We stopped by the SIG Zoo here in Manaus, Brazil, to see what kind of animals they have here. And I understand there's all kinds of birds and monkeys and tapirs and all kinds of neat stuff. But I wanted to see the jags. This is the jag enclosure right here behind me. Let's go see what kind of big cats they have hanging out here at the zoo. We stopped by the anaconda exhibit right at feeding time. These pen-raised rats had no fear of the snakes.
So cool.
Check it out, got a boa here at the SIG Zoo in Manaus, Brazil. They were cool enough to bring one out to us so we could hold it and get a better look at this incredible creature here. Check him out.
Look at that tongue.
Yeah.
Flick your tongue out, too.
If I let that thumb go, I'm sure he'll be trying to tie me up or all kinds of fun stuff. So
he'll put you in a Camorra.
Yeah. I might have found my match on this one, Will. I'm going to go ahead and hand it back to the professionals before I stress this guy out anymore. So what we got on?
We flew up the Rio Negro River to the town of Barcelos to meet the riverboat where we would spend the next week fishing. Hey, we made it to Barcelos right here on the bank of the Rio Negro River. It's known as the peacock bass fishing and tropical fish capital of the world. It was founded in 1728 and has over 27,000 residents. Behind me is one of the oldest churches in Brazil. It was built in 1728. We're going to take a quick tour before we go on the boat. We boarded the Blackwater Adventurer and headed north to the fishing areas. Well, we just arrived to our first fishing spot on the Rio Negro River here in Brazil. Now, it's been over 30 years since I was last here, and this is an incredible body of water. And catching peacock bass, it's an incredible fish. And we are in the jungle. This is an amazing environment, and I'm so excited to be here again to visit this place. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be throwing these lead-headed jigs with feathers on it, and I'm gonna be casting up in around these root wads and all these various cover structures, looking for predatory fish lurking in wait for something to eat. So that's how the game plan's gonna start. And I haven't made my first cast yet, but I'm about to now. So let's have some fun in Brazil catching peacock bass. The lead-headed jig. Jig it? All right. Give it a little bounce. Oh, he's making a run on me. There he is. Oh, he's kind of hooked around that stick, though. That's a big fish. All right, oh, here we go. Here we go. Got him, bingo. Pick him up. Look at Hoss. Look at Hoss. Man, look at the size of this guy. That's a beauty.
Jig, no chopper, no bite on chopper.
No bite on chopper?
No.
Bite on jig, right. Whoo, look at him. He's a beauty. Got your pliers handy? Yes, you do. Boy, at first, when he hit, I thought I might have hit another snag. And then I saw my line start moving and I knew it wasn't a snag, it was a fish. That's my first peacock bass in 30 years. You betcha, look at him, big boy. Look at the big boy. I got him, get your finger out. Okay, yeah. Look at him in the sun here, guys. Look at him in the sun, he's a beauty. All right, I'll bet that's probably 12, 13 pounds. What do you think?
No, 10.
10 pounds? 11 pounds? He's 12 or 13. All right, let's let him go.
13.
13 pounds?
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, I told you he was 11 or 12. All right, he just weighed him. I guesstimated him at around 11 or 12, and he turned out to be 13, so. Okay, big boy. And there he goes. No worse for wear. That was a beautiful fish. And the first fish of the day, of our first day here back in the Amazon, and the first peacock bass I've caught in over 30 years. And about lost him. He got into the sticks over here, kind of started weaving his way around, and I thought we were going to lose him for a minute there, but then we were able to untangle him, and he got the net. Good job, Manny, with the net. Manny goes, yep, yep, I got the net. Another good fish, feels like, too. Swam the end of that brush pile. Am I hung up now? Oh, there's still a fish on there. Oh, he spit it right there at the boat. That's funny. Jump for me. Speckled,
yeah,
and butterfly, huh? It's a hybrid.
This is exactly why we chose Leaf Filter.
Before Leaf Filter, our gutters would get so clogged.
I used to have to climb up on that roof.
Leaf Filter was a lifesaver.
The Leaf Filter installation process was so simple and easy.
When the salesman gave us interest-free financing and the price was right, it was a no-brainer.
Our downspouts flow freely now.
My home is better protected.
Thank you, Leaf Filter.
Call 833-LEAF-FILTER or go to leaffilter.com for your free gutter inspection and estimate. Call or log on today and save 15%.
This is exactly why we chose Leaf Filter.
Before Leaf Filter, our gutters would get so clogged.
I used to have to climb up on that roof.
Leaf Filter was a lifesaver.
The Leaf Filter installation process was so simple and easy.
When the salesman gave us interest-free financing and the price was right, it was a no-brainer.
Our downspouts flow freely now.
My home is better protected.
Thank you, Leaf Filter.
Call 833-LEAF-FILTER or go to leaffilter.com for your free gutter inspection and estimate. Call or log on today and save 15%.
Hey, Reno, how is your car looking? At Sierra Car Wash, a convenient clean is only minutes away. Visit any of our 11 express and full-service locations serving the Reno, Sparks, Carson City, and South Lake Tahoe communities. Save money on every car wash when you become a Sierra Unlimited member. Become an Unlimited member and never pay full price for a car wash again. No commitments, just clean. Find your neighborhood Sierra Car Wash at sierrawash.com.
There are a lot of reasons why people become attorneys. I wanted to help people. That's why I'm changing the game. Text me today and get an answer today. I don't get paid until you get paid. Simple, local, easy. Text or call me today.
Reel her in, Dad. Don't lose it.
Off on sticks.
I know. Keep reeling, he said.
Tried to bust me off on all these sticks here. Another good peacock bass. These fish are dark that we've been catching in here. They're very dark. Look at that. Got it. Okay, another hybrid. He's got the stripes and the butterfly on his tail. Yeah, there in the sun. All right. Nice. They're in here. You just got to hunt for them. Another good one. I'd say that's probably a 7-8 pounder right there. He's a beauty.
Mm-hmm.
He's a beauty. He almost got away, too. He's got some scars on him. Dolphin?
No, tree.
Tree scars. Okay. There he goes. Well, Manny, you stripped down like you were gonna go in after that fish. You took your clothes off. Are you gonna go in after that fish?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's commitment right there, guys.
Oh, that's funny, man.
Yeah, this water is real shallow, but it's got a lot of stick-ups and a lot of branches and stumps. And the buzzards are hanging out in there. We're trying to thread the needle to find them. Okay, another nice fish. They always find the sticks.
Light.
Loosen it.
Mm-hmm.
Loosen the line.
Open.
There he is. Okay. There he is. Not a monster. But he got in the sticks and caused his problems. Ha! What a deal. What a deal.
Lots of fish.
All right. Well, I think we found a little honey hole here after days of searching. We found us some bass. Feel good?
Yeah.
You did good, man. Thank you. All right. Manny took a bath. Okay. Turn him loose? Okay, buddy. And he's gone. All right, we found a honey hole here. Well, that's our show. Hope you enjoyed the action from the Rio Negro River in Brazil. Join me again next time for another exciting adventure on The Outdoorsman. For more info on fishing Brazil, contact Acute Angling at the following info. The Outdoorsman is brought to you by Outdoorsman International. Connect and subscribe via our social media pages.
Nevada Sportsnet is your home for all Wolfpack athletics.
Locally owned and operated for over 20 years, we do everything plumbing. And as the premier vendor for Rinnai, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your expert in tankless water heating technology with endless hot water on demand. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air to upgrade your system today.
I wonder if there's a Wolfpack game this week.
Go Wolfpack!
Hi, I'm Jack Stanko with Champion Chevrolet. We'll see you at this week's home game.
Go Pack!
When injured in an accident, seek justice, seek integrity, seek Nevada's trusted personal injury attorneys.
Go Lightly in Vanna, 222-3333.
We're the Jansons with SierraBuys.com.
We know the easiest way to sell your home.
If you have a few minutes, we hope that you'll give us the opportunity to make you an instant offer on your house. With SierraBuys.com, we'll buy your house in as-is condition with no inspection, no repairs, no closing costs, and no commissions. You can even choose your own closing date.
Call our dad for an offer on your house.
455-4500 to sell your house today.
Is your house catching a cold? It could be furnace problems. Schedule a tune-up today. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air for all your home heating needs. With over 20 years of being locally owned, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your go-to for home heating because we treat our customers like family.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome into Mountain West Conference basketball tonight from the Spectrum in Logan. Have we got a good one for you on tap? Nevada, the Wolfpack coming in at 17-5, and the Aggies, of course, of Utah State at 19-3. Dave Fox along with former Aggie great Gary Wilkinson. And Gary, it seems like every game, this is the 10th game we've done. It's our final broadcast before the networks take over. It seems like every game we're talking about some great guard. This Mountain West Conference is loaded with great guards. And here we go with Jared Lucas, another terrific one for Nevada.
Yeah, and this is a guard that's a little bit different in the sense he has a little bit more size than most guards. He's shooting a great clip from three-point with 39%. Had a big game last game. Look out, he's going to come out and be very aggressive tonight.
They absolutely annihilated. You talk about a good game, San Jose State in their last game. The Aggies coming off a loss. They were at San Diego State, tough place to play. We know that. But you know what? We got to circle back to great. Great needs to be great to get back to winning. Great Osabor, of course, the leading scorer for this team.
Yeah, and as he goes, so goes the Aggies. He's going to be a guy that they're going to throw it to early, have him establish a post presence, and then work through him offensively to get this team going.
So there you have it. It's as good as it gets in a Mountain West Conference battle. This is awesome. Two of the top teams in the league doing battle tonight. The Aggies hosting the Wolfpack, and it's coming your way locally on KMYU-TV, also in Reno, and of course on the Mountain West Network.
Let's go, let's go! Let's go, let's go! Let me help. Let me help.
You've got this. You've got this.
We're clearing out our inventory during Michael Hull Chevrolet GMC's winter clearance event. With a massive amount of new trucks ready for immediate delivery, we'll make you the deal of a lifetime. Save up to $10,000 off MSRP on new 2024 Chevy Silverado 1500s, or save up to $10,000 off MSRP on new 2024 GMC Sierra 1500s. Hurry, these savings won't last long. During the winter clearance event at Michael Hull Chevrolet GMC in Carson City, online at michaelhullgm.com.
This is the first new ad Bradley Adrenaline Janae has made in about 2 years. Instead of filming new ads, we've been doing what we do best, representing our clients after a life-changing accident or injury. And they need us working on their cases, not new commercials. So that's what we decided to film. Your work is more important than this. Bradley Adrenaline Janae, the number one law firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Road trip.
From the hip.
Roll with it.
Change your POV.
Driving UTV.
Tell reality, BRB.
Let your engines roar.
Try a new pour.
You never know what's in store.
See some OMG.
Maybe an ET.
Or the world's oldest trees.
Travel Nevada. Get a little out there.
Watch coverage of the big game all week long, presented by Circa Sportsbook inside Legends Bay Casino.
Again, Dave Fox along with Gary Wilkinson. And Gary, in Mountain West Conference play, the Wolfpack have never won in this building since they became Mountain West Conference foes. 0-10. Aggies lead the overall series 41-25, 24-6 overall in Logan.
I wonder how many teams that's true of in general. The Spectrum is a very difficult place to come in
extremely.
And play.
Extremely.
But Nevada's always put up a heck of a fight in the Spectrum.
Yeah, absolutely. In terms of the Ken Palm rankings, we love Ken because he's a local guy here, and a lot of people pay attention to his numbers. Nevada comes in at 53 and Utah State at 35. The Aggies dropped from 17-22. After the loss to San Diego State. Three Mountain West Conference teams ranked, though. The Aggies, San Diego State, and New Mexico. And here we go. And Ian Martinez. Shot won't go. And Nevada takes the basketball.
Nevada's a big team. They've got a big starting lineup. And it's that length and that athleticism is going to be an interesting matchup.
KJ Himes travels, trying to go at Great Osabor. You talked about that size, Gary. That battle between Himes, 6'10", 235-pound grad student, against the 6'8", 250-pound junior grade Osabor, that's going to be one for us to pay attention to throughout this game.
Absolutely. And I think Coach Alford, and is probably a lot of, like a lot of guys, go to your posts early. Let's see if we can get Osabor in foul trouble, because that seems to be the only way to stop him.
Well, it's worked the other way, but you're right.
And that's his MO, get the other team in foul trouble. As he gets it here, he's so difficult to defend down there.
So Himes picks up the foul, exactly what you were talking about, only with the other team. There's Steve Alford, the fifth-year coach here at Nevada. Storied coaching career, we know that. Coached at UCLA, New Mexico, Iowa. Terrific coach over the years. Played in the NBA with the Mavericks and the Warriors. Mm-hmm. Played for Bobby Knight. If you could survive Bobby Knight.
That's right.
I mean, you survived
Coach Morrill.
As the free throw goes, a pretty demanding coach in Coach Morrill, but I think that's a different level.
Yeah. I think you come out of getting coached by Bobby Knight, there's not much you can't handle in life.
Yeah, exactly. You know, I actually met him. I did an event with him in Salt Lake City after he had retired from Texas Tech, and really a great guy. I mean, just to sit down and talk with, and he's just a wonderful guy. There's Danny Sprinkle in his first season here with the Aggies. Came here from Montana State and brought a couple of pretty good players with him in Great Osmore and Darius Brown. All right, back into this post battle we were talking about. Although Himes kicks it out, and the Wolfpack will reset. And the drive. How about the little reverse up and in? Nick Davidson, who had a great game in that San Diego State throttling. Nevada won that one 90-60. And in that game, Nick Davidson had 22 points, 11 rebounds. Wide open, Darius Brown. Kept alive. Very active hands of Mason Falslev.
Yeah, that's one thing about Mason. It's his ability to come up with things.
Blocked in the post, out of bounds. It'll be Aggie ball.
Yeah, as a defender for Mason, your job doesn't end when the shot goes up. When he's at his most dangerous, is your ability to stop him and keep him off the boards, because he'll come up with those couple of those a game.
And he'll dive for a few loose balls. We'll see him all over the place.
Yep.
So you're absolutely right. And that ball tipped back out of bounds.
Well, and I'd have to say in this league, because it's so talented and close competitively, that it's plays like that that generally make the difference in close games. You know, the diving
hustle
on the floor,
plays.
The hustle,
yeah,
plays.
Right.
You don't see it, but in the end, it matters.
I like what you said about it. His job doesn't end when the shot goes
right
up, and it just doesn't. Lob into, boy, they are really making a concerted effort to get it into Osborne, but that time he was triple teamed. And Davidson throws it out of bounds, but it was tipped. So Nevada will keep the ball.
It's hard to anticipate the length of Osabor. It maybe looks like he can get it around him, but crowd didn't seem to like that. But
yeah, well,
that was a clear tip.
You can see right there is Osabor got it. Keenan Blackshear working in the post. And how about the defense from Ian Martinez? And the Aggies have it. And Martinez turns around into Osabor. Wisely resets. Osabor again. Oh, what a pass.
He attracts so much attention that there's people closing in on him. And he's a great passer. He'd be able to find his teammates.
And Johnson was wide open. Isaac Johnson, the sophomore transfer from Oregon out of American Fork. Backing up Martinez, but shot does not go for Blackshear.
And I think Nevada's trying to use their size advantage down in the block early. You've seen them just throw it to the post no matter who it is, because at every position they've got a few inches on the Aggies almost.
They really do. Oh, well, there's a block for Osabor, and the Aggies have it. Clean block on Daniel Foster. This battle in the post is so entertaining. Now it's Davidson working on Awesome. But if you look, every time he gets the ball, Gary, they send more players after him as Ian Martinez turns and hits.
And that's where you – and Ian Martinez has been so great as of late in terms of his confidence, his willingness to go out in there and try to create for his team. And Osabor needs that because, as you stated, they just pile on him when he gets it in the block. So you need your teammates to step up, spread the floor so that you have room to operate down there.
Davidson just forcing it up and in.
That's a great finish by Davidson.
Boy, is it.
It's tough to finish over a guy that size, and I think Johnson did a great job staying down, not going for any fakes and using his length, but sometimes offense is just better than good defense.
Darius Brown directing traffic, the senior. And what's the call here? There's a foul on the ground, not on the shot. So Blackshear picks up the foul. And the Aggies lead at 6-4. Good battle. We're early. Mountain West Conference basketball here locally on KMYU Television and the Mountain West Network.
I'm Jared Lucas, all-conference guard for the Nevada Wolfpack basketball team. The grind of the basketball season is long, and being able to go somebody that I trust like Dr. Morgan Rivetti can be central in being able to be adjusted and go into a game and feel great and play at a high level.
I come from a family of athletes, and treating our local athletes here in this community is something that's really important to our practice.
For appointments, call Northwest Reno Chiropractic at 775-324-3700 or go to northwestrenochiropractic.com.
If your personal injury attorney spends more time working on marketing than working on your case, you're probably in the market for a new personal injury attorney. At Bradley Drennel & Janae, our focus is on putting you first, not putting ourselves in front of the camera, which is why we didn't let our lawyers know we were filming today, so they'd keep their focus where it belongs, on you. Bradley Drennel & Janae, the number one law firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
With a Chevy, you get more than just a vehicle you can depend on. A Chevy gives you the freedom to explore new roads, to push the limits, and go places you've never been before. So buckle up and get ready to enjoy the ride as you set off on new adventures. See where a new Chevy will take you at Champion Chevrolet, home of the hardest working cars and trucks in America. Discover the new Chevy experience at Champion Chevrolet.
Are you ready to upgrade your home? Look no further than Envision Glass, your full-service glass experts. Our team of expert professionals offer a wide range of solutions, from residential repairs to full installations, to fit your budget with free in-home estimates. With Envision Glass, you can expect on-time arrivals, the highest quality materials, and exceptional workmanship, and installations are backed by our 5-year warranty. Trust the full-service glass experts. Choose Envision Glass for all your glass repair and upgrade needs. Visit envisionglass.com.
Back here in Logan. I want to mention a longtime donor and Aggie supporter, Kirk Hansen. Good friend of this program for many, many years. Sadly passed away this past weekend after a battle with cancer. Our condolences to his family. Kirk Hansen, great longtime Aggie fan and supporter. Again, we wish all the best for his family as he lost his battle. But he's here every game up until... He unfortunately passed away, but you're always sitting up in those seats right behind the scorer's table. Aggies leading by two, and they now have the basketball as Jared Lucas. We talked about Lucas early on, averaging 17 points a game, the Oregon State transfer, but not able to get – oh, Alcibor had that in his hand. And they're going to call a foul on Alcibor.
Yeah, it was hard to see from where we're sitting. Yeah, it didn't look like anyone had control over that. Sometimes we get replays. Sometimes we don't.
We are at the mercy, full disclosure, of the in-house Jumbotron system. They do a great job, but sometimes we're able to get any replays. Sometimes we're not. Just give you a little heads up on how the broadcast system works. But like I said, our crew does a really good job for us here. Ian Martinez. Josh Shaduje, by the way, into the game now. And Brown steps up. And Darius hits the three.
That's the type of ball movement. As you see, it gets moved around the perimeter. They penetrate, have the defense close in, and find wide open shooters. That's what creates good offense. Sometimes the Aggies have a tendency to become a little bit more stagnant in the half court when it doesn't go into Osabor. That was a good possession.
Darius Brown, a 33% three-point shooter, is going the other way. Keenan Blackshear hits. Much-needed hoop for Nevada, 9-6 game. And I mentioned Josh Adugie checking in. Almost always the first one in for Isaac Johnson, averaging 9 points a game. One of two players on this team from England, he and Great Osabor. And Adugie fires away. Osabor, oh, the ball went off his foot. False of thought about the three. This might be an offensive foul. And it is. Let's take a look.
Yeah, he kind of dipped his shoulder a little bit. As a home fan, you want to see those get let go.
Yeah.
As the opposing side, you want that called. So.
Yeah, the Aggie fans love it. The herd, as they call them, the Aggies fans, they all got free T-shirts tonight, so they're extra happy as Davidson's three will not go.
It doesn't take much for college students. Free
no,
ice
doesn't.
Cream, free T-shirts.
And anything free.
Yeah, that's true.
Ian Martinez. Not really a three-point shooting clinic so far in this game. Utah State 1 of 4. And Nevada has not hit one.
The one thing that you'll want to watch throughout this game is a lot of times teams come out and they double down on Osabor and they, for some reason, don't do that throughout the game because they feel like they've got him contained.
Three-pointer. Mason Falslev lights up the crowd.
They've got him contained. But that's when he starts to really make his move because they start to back off him a little bit and give him more space to operate. Then that's when he starts to put up his numbers.
Layup at the other end. And we got a whistle because we've got a flat. Mason came out of his wheel. Shoes back on. We're ready to go. Falslev's had a nice season, averaging 11 points. A young man who in high school played basketball and football. We've talked a lot about just how good he was. Well, his team won the state championship his senior year in both sports. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, he's built like a football and a basketball player.
He kind of is. Yeah, you're right. He was the MVP in his 4A football season. But he's loving it here. He played high school ball just a few miles up the road. Khalifa Sacco into the game, number 34, along with Javon Jackson. So Danny Sprinkle going to his bench with three subs in right now. Darius Brown dishes Falslev. Shot clock about to expire, and that one's blocked. Big block for Trey Coleman. But the shot clock expired, so it will be Nevada basketball when we come back. Aggies with a 12-8 lead early on. But a game like this, it's going to be a battle throughout the evening here on KMYU and the Mountain West Network.
Since 1874, the University of Nevada, Reno has been shaping young minds and bringing Nevada's best to the world. We're celebrating our 150th anniversary. From the silver boom to sustainability, the university has always been a leader in innovation and discovery. Here we live the Wolfpack way, where students strive to be their best, pursue their passions, and make a difference. Join us in celebrating 150 years of inspiring excellence. Go Pack!
Locally owned and operated for over 20 years, we do everything plumbing. And as the premier vendor for Rinnai, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your expert in tankless water heating technology with endless hot water on demand. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air to upgrade your system today.
Okay, let's do some math. One, huge selection. Two, no dealer markups. Three, lower taxes. Four, 65 miles to savings. You don't have to be a mathematician to see these numbers add up to Wild West Chevrolet being the smart choice. What's your number? Check us out online or in Yerington.
We've been in the biggest little city since its very beginning. We brought clean water to our city's first buildings and homes when that wasn't easy to do. As our city has grown, we've grown with it. Since 1893, we've been trusted to do the right things the right way. Whether it's delivering innovative ideas for the buildings shaping our future, or making sure your leaky faucet leaks no more. That's the Savage way. And it has been for over 130 years.
Is your house catching a cold? It could be furnace problems. Schedule a tune-up today. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air for all your home heating needs. With over 20 years of being locally owned, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your go-to for home heating because we treat our customers like family.
Back here in Logan, Mountain West Conference basketball. The Aggies coming off that loss at San Diego State, but still leading the league, both Aggies and Boise State at 7-2. The Aggies actually beat Boise State last week, but they're playing this Saturday. And what'll be a pretty big night as Lucas puts up the shot and does not go. They will be renaming the court. Stu Morrill Court, very well deserved here, as great Asabor and one. And that's two fouls now on K.J. Hines.
Yeah, and that's I can't emphasize enough how big of the points and the rebounds are one thing. But the amount of pressure he puts on your defenders to put them in foul trouble is a completely different story. And that's teams have to adjust. They can't – it's hard to put your best defender on him or a player that puts up points because you don't want to have those points taken off the floor because they get in foul trouble.
And so as a result, Himes has to go to the bench. And we've seen Nick Davidson on him, but to your point, I mean, how much do you want Nick Davidson to have to deal with great Asabor?
Right. Because you're going to
– he's one of your better scorers.
That's right. So. That's the strategic problem that great Asabor
– Yep. That's the dilemma.
Right.
That he creates for opponents. With his free throws now, the Aggies opening up a 15-8 lead. Davidson in the post, and he traveled. The officials say that's Kevin Brill, our official there. A travel. Ryan Holmes and Scott Brown also officiating this game. Take a look.
Yeah, they have that cross-screen action going below, and that's a great play. The Aggies just read it and put two players down there to make it a little bit more difficult for Davidson.
Yeah, and he looked like he thought that somebody was behind him, and he was going to be leaning into him,
right,
and he just fell down.
The one thing is Nevada's leaving these corners wide open because they're sitting their corner guys down on the post.
Worried about Gray.
Yeah.
Martinez, right place, right time for the rebound, but shot won't go. Martinez from Costa Rica, transfer from the University of Utah and Maryland. Boy, he's been really good for the Aggies this year, averaging 14 points a game. Second leading scorer on the team behind Asabor. Into the post, Davidson again turns and scores. Asabor obviously being a little careful himself.
And Davidson's very smart in terms of his positioning. He'll sit a position when the ball's on his side of the court that he's anticipating when the ball moves. He's going to have, just like on that play, great position to just a little baby hook into the basket.
Davidson from Mission Viejo, California, played at Mater Dei, that powerhouse football and basketball school. And turnover. You see Darius Brown read that the moment they threw it out. You got to be careful when Asabor's up at the top of that three-point line. He'll let it fly.
Yeah.
He's shot eight three-pointers this year and made three of them. Look at Ian Martinez back his way in, but cannot connect. And that will go over to Nevada.
Hey, and this game, Nevada's been so scrappy. They're getting their hands on a lot of basketballs. Usually great is able to come down with a few of those offensive rebounds, but they're in there fighting, scrapping, making it really difficult for him to come down and play the game that he's used to be playing.
And Blackshear loses the ball, but they get it back. Osabor on this end, also defending Davis. A Blackshear turn. Shot will go, and great stepped out of bounds on the rebound. So Nevada will keep the basketball. Neither one of these teams putting on a shooting clinic. They're both right around 35%. And Nevada's still looking for their first three. The Aggies have a couple of them, but
yeah, that didn't go out of bounds at all. It did look
you saw
like
there.
It. Yeah.
And there's your redemption. The Aggies get the ball back. As I said, neither team really shooting great, and that's an example of it. Boy, Asabar draws a crowd. And then, after he draws a crowd, Aduje gets his shot blocked.
Yeah, no one's getting anything easy here.
Except Blackshear right there. Right on cue, Gary.
Except for that.
That was definitely too easy. Brown and Aduje again. This time he hits Josh Aduje, Coastal Carolina transfer.
Sometimes you get easy shots off of broken offenses. It's a defense out of sorts, but that was good defense by Nevada.
Aggies had missed their previous four shots before that one went in, so they needed it. And at the other end, Nevada answers. Good ball game. 17-14, 8 minutes to go here in the first half of a crucial Mountain West battle. Nevada 4-4. They're a little ways way down in the standings as that shot is missed, but the Aggies trying to hang on to the top spot. And if they win tonight along with Boise State, you're going to be looking at two teams battling for first place Saturday night here, but a big three on their way by Trey Coleman. And Nevada is going to have a lot to say about this game tonight. We are tied up. Anyone's ball game.
Yeah, there's no nights off in this league.
Nope. Martinez takes the ball for a ride. Can't get the shot to go, but he will be shooting free throws after the foul from Trey Coleman. We got a good one. Tight ball game here. Mountain West Conference basketball.
Those were wild times. Betting squares for the big game has come a long way.
Now with the Circus Sports app, you can select your Circus squares right at your fingertips.
Everyone's played traditional squares at a big game watch party. Here at Circus Sports, we do it a whole lot better.
Select your own squares and as many as you want.
$1 minimum bet and a $100,000 maximum payout.
And best of all, no more arguing over the squares.
Circus Squares brought to you by Circus Sports, the world's largest sports book at your fingertips.
With a Chevy, you get more than just a vehicle you can depend on. A Chevy gives you the freedom to explore new roads, to push the limits, and go places you've never been before. So buckle up and get ready to enjoy the ride as you set off on new adventures. See where a new Chevy will take you at Champion Chevrolet, home of the hardest working cars and trucks in America. Discover the new Chevy experience at Champion Chevrolet.
This is what a fight looks like. That's right. This is an attorney at Bradley Drendel & Janae fighting for a client. It may be hard to tell, but he's winning big. Maybe we should add some fight sound effects to make it more thrilling to watch at home. Okay, watching us fight isn't that exciting, unless you're the client that just notched a big win. Bradley Drendel & Janae, the number one firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Can't choose between watching your favorite Mountain West team on TV or going everywhere else you need to be? With the official Mountain West app, you don't have to. Watch hundreds of Mountain West games and championship events, live or archived, from wherever you are, all for free with the Mountain West app. Available on mobile and connected TV devices. Download the Mountain West app today.
Always a good time here at the Spectrum in Logan, and a packed house tonight. Saturday's game already sold out as Boise State comes to town. And your team, the 2008-2009 team that you played on, will also be honored that night, in addition to the court being renamed the Stu Morrill Court. Martinez, as the place goes deadly silent. 83% free throw shooter. It's amazing, for as loud as this place can get, how quiet it can get.
Yeah, I always
when
feel
there are guys at the line. Yeah,
I feel bad talking during free throws.
I know, I do too. Yeah, it's there. It's a very knowledgeable basketball crowd here. They know when to let them have it and when not to. Layup. You were talking about too easy. Well, there you go, Nick Davidson. I kind of get the sense that Osborne is being really careful with him in the post. Not that Great's in any sort of foul trouble. He's only got one. Nevada on a little bit of a tear. They've made their last four shots in a row. See if they can keep it going. Short little jumper, no. So that's their first miss after four consecutive makes.
Yeah, they have the athleticism and the scoring ability to make things happen. Aggies have had a couple open looks.
Boy, look at that. As soon as Osborne gets the ball, Gary, triple team. And here comes Tyler Rollison. And just like that, I mean, that's exactly what they tried to draw. Get the ball from Great, race down and score.
And that's the thing. If their strategy is, look, let's make everybody else beat us. We're going to just double team. If he has to kick it out and they beat us off threes, then we're going to live with that. And that's exactly what's happening here. They're making everybody else beat them. But Great Osabor.
Yeah, they do not. Every time he touches the ball, they're all over him. Now we got a foul on, I believe this is on Blackshear.
Yeah, didn't have his feet set as he's sliding over for that one. He was close, though.
So they're not shooting. Sabor skips it over to Brown, and Brown's three is short, and shooting woes continue. The Aggies now shooting right around 30%, while Nevada is up to close to 50%. Nevada has definitely found the range, 10 of 21 on their field goals, and a three, and that goes for Nick Davidson. And Davidson having a heck of a game. He's now got 11, which is his average. And we're not even at halftime yet.
When I think of the way that the Aggies play defense in terms of switching or hedging out on that high ball screen, is really playing it in Nevada's favor when you got a guy like Davidson who can pick and pop, because there's no one to rotate to Davidson. You're stuck
right
there. So Osabor's got to help and then get back to recover for him. Right here is a perfect example. There's no one to help.
Yeah, that's a lot to ask, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not really a lot to ask, but it's a lot to remember.
Yeah, there's a lot of movement.
That was a great example you just showed right on that last possession. Blackshear right to the rack, and that goes. And now Nevada on a run, and they have built up a seven-point lead.
Yeah, it's just the little things they're coming up with plays here. They're being aggressive offensively, and they're sharing the basketball. I mean, if you look at their scoring, it's pretty well balanced. I mean, you have Davidson who's putting up big numbers, but every guys are willing to shoot, whereas Utah State, they're trying to push it into Osabor, and other guys are hesitant. I've watched him pass up a number of wide-open shots, And sometimes that hurts your team more than just taking a shot and missing it.
Well, and as a result, Nevada is on a 9-0 run and has given them their biggest lead of this game.
And that's where Utah State, that's what Coach Sprinkle has really impressed me a lot this year, is his ability to make in-game adjustments. A lot of times you'll see them go into a half and completely come out with a new strategy in the second half, and they're able to kind of pull away and whittle away at leads and so on and so forth. So I'd be aware of the in-game adjustments that Coach Sprinkle might make from here on out.
Well, he's going to need to make them, because the Aggies have only made one of their last 10 field goal attempts. That's unreal. And they haven't scored in nearly 3 minutes of game time.
Yep, everyone's got to be ready to shoot.
Yeah, their shooting percentage, Gary's down to 27%, 6 of 22. Martinez three, and he got it. Oh, the Aggies needed that. Ian now with 7 points to lead Utah State. Lucas, so good in the post when he drives in and creates that shot.
That's a tough play to stop. His ability to elevate over his defender and just put in a little short jumper.
How about the drive, but a block. Davidson gets up and swats away Mason Falslev. And then a corner three, that's short. And we talked about Falslev will be on the court more than once tonight, and there you go. Diving for that loose ball. Asabor. And there's a foul. Oh, that's going to be on. Well, that's on Blackshear. Hines isn't even in the game right now.
So. Yeah. They're both battling down here for position.
Blackshear now with three fouls. And a little extracurricular going on.
Are you ready to upgrade your home? Look no further than Envision Glass, your full-service glass experts. Our team of expert professionals offer a wide range of solutions, from residential repairs to full installations, to fit your budget with free in-home estimates. With Envision Glass, you can expect on-time arrivals, the highest quality materials, and exceptional workmanship. And installations are backed by our 5-year warranty. Trust the full-service glass experts. Choose Envision Glass for all your glass repair and upgrade needs. Visit EnvisionGlass.com.
Locally owned and operated for over 20 years, we do everything plumbing. And as the premier vendor for Rinnai, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your expert in tankless water heating technology with endless hot water on demand. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air to upgrade your system today.
With a Chevy, you get more than just a vehicle you can depend on. A Chevy gives you the freedom to explore new roads, to push the limits, and go places you've never been before. So buckle up and get ready to enjoy the ride as you set off on new adventures. See where a new Chevy will take you at Champion Chevrolet, home of the hardest working cars and trucks in America. Discover the new Chevy experience at Champion Chevrolet.
Some personal injury lawyer ads show them in a boxing ring or catching air on a mountain bike. Some are riding horses or mucking out a barn. Very authentic. But for our ad, we're just going to show you our personal injury lawyers being personal injury lawyers. After all, that's what we do best. Exciting, isn't it? Bradley Drenaline Janae, the number one law firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Is your house catching a cold? It could be furnace problems. Schedule a tune-up today. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air for all your home heating needs. With over 20 years of being locally owned, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your go-to for home heating, because we treat our customers like family.
Watch high school basketball on Champion Chevrolet's High School Hoops, presented by America First Credit Union. Tune in Friday at 7 on NSN.
And then he turns, says something to one of the fans.
Yeah.
I'm sure the fans were, you know, being really nice as well. Yeah. Inside the post, Johnson, up and in, and one. I Isaac Johnson.
And that's what Osabor needs. He needs his teammates to step up, start making plays. Martinez on that three here. Johnson gets great position, is able to finish through contact. That's going to start opening things up for Osabor because they can't double down like they've been doing and leave other guys open who are scoring the basketball.
Talk about a basketball family. Isaac's brother, Spencer, at BYU. After playing at UVU, actually BYU's his fourth school, and he's found a home. And then his sister Gracie's on the Utah State women's basketball team. A lot of basketball in that family.
Some good genes.
Yep. All right, well, that trims the lead to three for Nevada. Blackshear on the bench picking up that other foul. Davidson bobbled the pass but gets it off, and an and-one going the other way. So Daniel Foster gets the hoop in the harm, as they say, and Johnson with the foul.
The thing is Johnson leaves his feet. That makes it easy for a ref to make a call. If he just stays down and uses his length, that's a harder call to make.
Foster, a 61% free throw shooter. Young man out of Melbourne, Australia, connects.
I played there Australia.
You?
Well, I lived in New Zealand. We played in the Australian League. So they had Melbourne Tigers when I was there.
So you had to go all the way from New Zealand to Melbourne for all your games.
I had to go to, New Zealand, Perth. From New Zealand to Perth, to Sydney, to Wollongong.
Oh, my word.
All over Australia. I've been to more places in Australia than the United States.
That's a lot of miles. Great tries of three. It doesn't go. Yeah, people don't realize how far it is to go all the way over to Perth.
Yeah.
Other side of the country. A big country.
Yeah, beautiful, too.
Yeah, it is. I've been to Melbourne before. But I didn't realize you played down there. All this conversations we've had about your overseas playing, I never heard Australia come up. You're too humble.
Yeah.
Osabor, and great delivers. And now, they're calling an offensive foul, Gary, away from the ball on Isaac Johnson.
Yeah, he looks like he sealed his defender on the way down. It might be hard to see.
Okay. Well, and they looked right at him.
Yeah.
So Isaac Johnson.
I can't say I disagree with that call.
Yeah. They were trying to sub him out, and then they started playing. So Danny Springle had to motion him back in, and here's another foul and one. Nevada just putting it to the Aggies in terms of fouling.
Martinez is saying he hooked him here.
Oh, wow. That had to hurt. So Nevada up by 8 and free throws coming. A chance to extend the lead to 10. Trey Coleman, a 73% free throw shooter. And he's got it. Aggies fall behind now, by 9, not 10. Look at that. Triple team, double team, triple team. And Osabor gets it to Falsley. Nevada on a tear, folks. They've made 6 of their last 8 field goal attempts.
Can you give any team in this league a little bit of confidence and a little bit of green light? And they have the talent, they have the ability to start making runs like they've made here.
And it's halted by a turnover. But as we approach a minute to play, Nevada really playing strong in the last few minutes of this half. USA! Brown trying to hit a three. Can't get that to go. Under a minute.
And that defense that Nevada's in forces you to play on the perimeter. It's very difficult to get in the post because they just sit their guys there. And Utah State kind of fell in the trap of just passing it around and then just settling for a out-of-offense three. That's exactly what that defense is designed to do.
Well, 30-second timeout here, so Danny Sprinkle, they'll get the ball back. There's 44 seconds in the half, 25 on the shot clock. But, you know, among other things, Gary, they just got to find their shot.
Yeah.
They're being outshot 53% to 32%. Very uncharacteristic.
Well, and we've talked about this in past games. That's because most of their offense comes through Osabor. Their percentages
right.
come through Osabor. And when he's getting swarmed like he is tonight, the shots that they usually are used to aren't coming where they're used to having them be. So that will probably account for some of the percentage. The other thing is, yeah, they just need to find their shot.
Well, you bring up a great point in that Osabor, when was the last time he only had two field goals at halftime?
Right.
I'm talking about attempts. He's only made one of them.
Right.
But just two. He's one for two. He's got three free throws.
And
that's just not an Osabor night.
No.
Credit Nevada.
Right. Credit to Nevada. I mean, they've prepped and they've tried to find a way to find his kryptonite because most teams in this haven't this year.
No. I mean, even the loss to San Diego State, he had 17 points and 7 rebounds, averaging nearly 20 a game, and he only has 5. Lucas, step back jumper. He is so good.
See, that looked a lot like the offensive foul that got called on Faltzlove down here when he dipped his shoulder. But the rest didn't see it that way.
All right, final possession for the Aggies here. Leduje looks like he wanted to take that corner three. Now he'll throw one up. It skims off the front of the rim. And not a good finish to this first half for the Aggies. It's been a struggle, shooting just 31%. Nevada, Gary, hitting 55% of their shots.
Yeah, and that's good defense leads to good offense. A lot of their points have come out of transition and turnovers, getting stops. And they have there seems like they're running downhill on the Aggies in terms of their offensive play.
Well, we're going to step away for our halftime activities. Locally, we'll be on KMYU for halftime and also the Mountain West Network. Aggies right now trailing Nevada 36-27.
At The Joint Chiropractic, we believe that everyone should have access to high-quality, affordable chiropractic care. You are never too young or too old to start taking care of your body. Walk-ins are welcome at any of our 5 Northern Nevada locations for just $29, 7 days a week. Plus, as a monthly member, you can get treatment at any of our 900 nationwide locations. Stop living with pain. Try The Joint Chiropractic today and give your body the relief it needs.
Child hunger is real.
Many Northern Nevada children go an entire day or even a weekend with nothing to eat. With your help, we can make a difference.
For just $5, you can help a hungry child eat on the weekend.
Join Dollar Loan Center and News 4 at Smith's on South Meadows Parkway February 9th or donate to the Super Bowl of Caring at MyNews4.com.
Help make a difference today. Donate to the Super Bowl of Caring.
Okay, let's do some math. 1, huge selection. 2, no dealer markups. 3, lower taxes. 4, 65 miles to savings. You don't have to be a mathematician to see these numbers add up to Wild West Chevrolet being the smart choice. What's your number? Check us out online or in Yerington.
You're watching Nevada Sportsnet.
Academic and personal growth that is beyond compare. Our students learn at the peak of achievement. And as our more than 5,000 student athletes take the field of play with unequaled passion, you'll find us performing at the peak of competition. The Mountain West is at the peak.
It's really hard to coach, you know? There's this array of emotions, and we talk about that that's how you feel alive. It's almost, in some ways, you know, relatable to being a parent. You will never love your children more, and you will never be more upset and angry at a human being, right? It's just every emotion that you could possibly have, and it's the same coaching.
In the 4 years that I've been here, there certainly have been days where practices aren't as clean as we would like them. But I don't think we've ever had to ask for more effort. The effort is there. Our players are hustling and throwing themselves around the gym. And so it has just created such an incredible training environment.
You know, there's never more struggle or introspection or feeling like, okay, we're somehow letting them down or somehow they're not getting the experience they need or, you know, we haven't been good enough for them, or in some ways, you know, we haven't trained them well enough for the moments that they need to be in. But then there's nothing more elating and nothing more exciting than seeing them accomplish amazing things. And it almost got, I don't know, rote, where we just kept talking about, you guys have done unprecedented things. Look at these things you've done. They haven't been done since 1978 when we won a national championship. Look at what you've done, 20 win seasons.
And I think that's like one of the best things Rob has done for us, is given us every opportunity to really push ourselves. Like, you know, some other teams in the Mountain West, you know, had successful preseasons, but not nearly the level of competition that we faced. When Rob told us in the spring,
you guys, this is what we're gonna do for the preseason. We're going to play at Nebraska.
We laughed. We were like, you're not being serious.
What, are you serious?
It's like, good, yeah, how'd you get that one, you know?
We're playing Nebraska, first game at their place, home opener for them. And we were like, wow, like, what a way to start off our season, like, number one team in the country, and we get to go there and experience that. And so showing up there, 9,000, 10,000 fans in those stands, it's like, wow, like,
pretty sure that's gotta be every volleyball little girl's dream. I mean, it's so iconic, like Go Big Red, like that is the stage.
We wanted to challenge ourselves in the biggest ways and see how we could perform on the biggest stages. Playing two really competitive teams in SMU and Lipscomb that are at the top of their conference every year. We're gonna come back home and we're gonna play Utah and Weber.
A sold out crowd for our first game was something super special. Just to be back here, especially from our last season, especially to sweep Utah, who's always awesome. You always want to win, especially when it's someone in state like Utah, in front of a 1488 fire marshal maxed out capacity. And it was rocking in there for that first home match of the season.
We as a team, we played really well that game and we deserved it ultimately. And just having the support of the community here and the support of our coaches was a great way to start our season off at home.
I mean, I wish on you a disastrous trip to Texas where you get hammered and you lose some matches and you have team drama and nothing goes right and everything is a struggle and there's all these problems that happen. And
Texas presented us a lot of issues on and off the court, and as hard as Texas was for us, it was a great catalyst for success for the rest of the year. It taught us a lot, and I think if you ask anyone about it, they'll kind of laugh about it because they know how hard it was, but I don't think we'd be where we were if we didn't have that tournament. Done. Close that chapter. Never talk about that again.
there's just so much more to be learned sometimes from adversity than there is from success, because of the introspection, because of those hard moments where you really start to realize who you are and what you're about. 17-1 in conference is an unbelievable accomplishment from this team. It's really tough. And I don't know that you do it without such a senior level group, right? Some people that are so savvy and understand how to prepare themselves, right? Tatum and Shelby and Bia and, you know, Kennedy Boyd and, you know, just on and on. We have all of these seniors and all of this leadership where, you know, they were able to handle kind of the ups and downs and travel and all the difficulties and just be great.
And I know Rob says things just don't happen, but like for us, like in practice, it was the work we were constantly putting in, and again, had that same mentality of like, this is one at a time. And we knew that these teams couldn't touch us. And even our one loss, I'm sure you ask any single person on our team, we would love to get that one loss back. We fell to Air Force in five sets, 15-13 in the fifth. I think having that loss pretty early in the season kind of took a little bit of pressure off us. Like, it wasn't like, oh, when's the first loss gonna come? It was just like, we shouldn't have lost that, and now we're gonna show everyone why we shouldn't have lost that. The atmosphere we created here and the way that the crowd can just energize our team, like, we just played such tough volleyball the whole season, 3 months of just incredible playing. And it was just this mentality of like, for sure you're not coming into our place and taking anything from us. And then when we were on the road, it was like, now we're gonna show you what's up.
We're just always laughing and like cracking jokes before a point, and it probably makes the other teams like hate us, like, what is wrong with these people? It's so funny because people in our conference, they wanted what we had.
I mean, I've had friends on the other teams and they tell me it's not the best experience, but they'll say, you got a great student section at your school. And I'm like, these kids are awesome.
Bleachers breaking that happened at BYU. They were just so hype and jumping. Ugh, they were just, I'm surprised that they didn't break more of those bleachers. It was so fitting for the herd, honestly, though. I think that should be their goal. It shouldn't be their goal. Just kidding, don't add that in there, but that is just the definition of how much support that they've had for us all season.
You're free on a Thursday night, you know exactly where you're going. You're going to the SS. He really worked with the herd. They got some specific cheers down. They got to understand the game of volleyball a little bit better, and so I think that made it more exciting for them.
To now in 2023, the herd be just dialed in with cheers and giving the other team some grief has been really cool and really fun to watch.
But every match we would have people come up and say, that's the first volleyball game I've ever been to, and that is the funnest environment I've ever seen, and holy cow, look at your team. And so it's just been amazing to kind of watch it grow and watch it build. And again, created a lot of these really emotional moments for me where you look around and you think, man, this is exactly what we were after, and this is exactly what we thought could happen when we first came here. Man, look at what these players and this team has built.
Our players are the magic. Without them, we don't have anything. So they are a special group that comes in and competes every single day, that are just a bunch of winners that attack life, that are dialed in, and they are the ones that the herd come to see. Well, maybe they come to see Rob too, but I think most of the time they're here to see the players.
For all the championships and all the consistency and the great play, for me the most memorable is to see our players in the face of adversity be them their best selves. And I think that character and that example in the face of the toughest moments that we had during the season really resonates and helps to explain why we were able to be so consistent. You know, it's easy to be good when things are good. It's really hard to be good when you feel terrible and, you know, emotionally you're drained. And that's the group that we had. And that's the type of player that I want, the player that can be at their best when things aren't good. Like, any attacker can kill a set when it's set perfectly. I want the attacker that can resolve a situation when a ball isn't set perfectly. And that's what our players became and continue to become and continue to work to become. Players that aren't going to stress out when things aren't perfect. They're just going to be committed to being their best. And man, that's the group that we have.
At Key Acura, we know that the purchasing experience is just as important as the car you drive. That's why we offer our limited engagement sales process, making your purchase quick, seamless, and smooth. Find yours at Key Acura of Reno.
Hi, I'm Peđa Stojaković.
I'm Andre.
He got his size from me, his jump shot from me, and his feet also from me.
Wow, thanks.
To take care of those feet, I got him the Good Feet 3-Step Arch Support System.
Good Feet Arch Supports are designed to help relieve foot-related pain by putting the foot into a more ideal pain-relieving position.
These feel great. Everybody needs Good Feet, even my son.
From seed to cup, every step of this process is important, but most of all, we get to roast the coffee here in Reno, Nevada. As a former Nevada track athlete, giving back to my alma mater means the world to me. Morning Howl Coffee is our way of doing that. For every bag sold, whether it's at our cafes, online, or at grocery stores, a portion of those proceeds go back to Nevada Athletics. Go Pack!
Auto accident injuries can be debilitating. Pain can cause problems with normal daily activities, recreational activities, and returning to work. Almost 40 years ago, my dad opened Northwest Reno Chiropractic with the goal of getting people quickly out of pain and back to normal daily activities through chiropractic care tailored to a patient's individual needs. No long treatment plans, no unnecessary visit, just getting people feeling better. For appointments, call Northwest Reno Chiropractic at 775-324-3700 or go to northwestrenochiropractic.com.
At Key Acura, we know that the purchasing experience is just as important as the car you drive. That's why we offer our limited engagement sales process, making your purchase quick, seamless, and smooth. Find yours at Key Acura of Reno.
Back here in Logan, good to have you with us tonight. Dave Fox, Gary Wilkinson, Aggies taking on Nevada. And the Wolfpack leading 36-27. What jumps out at you, Gary, other than the obvious shooting woes for Utah State at 31%, while Nevada's at 55?
Yeah, I mean, I think for the most part, it's evenly matched. For me, it's defensively how tenacious Nevada's playing. It's hard to tell that from the stat sheet because they're, you know, aside from the shooting percentages, you really can't tell that, but they're taking away a lot of the things that the Aggies have done well throughout this year. So that's what's jumping out at me in this first half. We'll see what adjustments they make.
Well, and Gray's Osabor definitely needs to get it going. He's really struggled. One of two fewest. He's only put up two shots. I can tell you that hasn't happened in a half this season. And we've done the last 10 home games. This is our 10th game, our final game of the season. It's been a lot of fun for us. But so far, the Aggies 9-0 when we're broadcasting. And Nevada's having a little something to say about that.
Right.
But right on the first possession, two misses. One from Nevada, one from Utah State. As Ian Martinez is thwarted on his attempt there. By the way, number 42, KJ Hines, back into the game. Had some pretty bad foul trouble early on. Two quick ones. Never got his third, so that's good for Nevada.
Yeah, generally when you pick up two in the first half, you're done. Ride the bench until next half, and it's not a fun position to be in as a player.
And each team had two players with two fouls, but nobody's gotten to three yet. And that pass a little high. Looks like Blackshear just pushed on. Just as I said, nobody's gotten to three fouls. Blackshear picks up his third foul.
Yeah, and that's what the Aggies need to do. They need to get it into the post and put a little pressure on them from the inside. That's what they try to do with Osabor, but he's just getting swarmed down there this game.
trying to feed that ball into Falslev. And Jared Lucas picks up the foul. So two quick ones. Now Lucas with two. And Blackshear with three. Oh, okay, so they're saying now that's his first foul. They actually had him down for one, but that must have been wrong. Three-pointer on the way from the corner, and Johnson can't find the range. That's his first three-point attempt. Didn't even attempt one in the first half. Lucas, oh, he's so good, so fast. But in this case, Brown is there to prevent the shot from going in. Here we go. Johnson again, and Johnson flips up that little hook shot that won't go in, nearly commits a foul, and Osibor steals it. And Great, up and in. And Great's like, how do I get a foul call here? At the other end, there's the flush. K.J. Himes makes him pay.
The Aggies are slow to transition back, and on a play like this, you either just let it go or you make sure that he doesn't finish the dunk. Nothing cheap, nothing that would hurt a player. You can't let him get two easy ones like that.
So Johnson just picked up his third. And Carson Templin's going to check in. And you know, much like you were talking about two fouls in the first half, you pick up your third foul in the first minute and a half of the second half, you're also going to the bench.
And right now you can see Nevada's playing with like they want this game more. They're coming up with the things that they need to. They're making plays when they need to. Those are all the things that are evidence of focus and preparation in terms of what this game was going to be. And I think Nevada's come out with a little bit more focus in this game so far.
Carson Templin, by the way, number 24, checking in out of Fairview, Texas. And there's the three. Mason Falslev. Boy, the Aggies needed that one. And Mason's the best three-point shooter in this game. Offensive foul. And this is a big one. So K.J. Himes had the two quick fouls in the first half, and now he's got his third. And so far, they're leaving him in, 17:50 to play.
Now, if I was Utah State, I'd go right at him.
Yep.
In terms of when you have a player in foul trouble, you just got to exploit that weakness.
Well, right now, Osibor standing out by the three-point line as Falslev a little too hot on that layup. Himes turns in, tries to score the hook over Templin, and they're going to call a foul on Templin. So for Nevada, you've got Blackshear and Himes each with three fouls, and for Utah State, you've got Johnson each with three fouls. And Himes going to the free throw line. KJ, a 60% free throw shooter.
And I think Carson did a good job on that one, moving his feet, making defenders score over him. Sometimes you get that contact, puts pressure on the ref to make a call, and sometimes it goes your way, sometimes it doesn't.
This crowd, they are so good. Well, there's what you're looking at if you're shooting free throws. And Himes connects on the second. So, as I said, 60% free throw shooter. He goes one for two on that trip, although he had missed his previous one as well.
Right.
Aggies need to get something rolling here.
Good hands.
Carson Templin. And Templin scores in the post.
It's nice for guards when you can kind of throw a ball up there and you can depend on your bigs to have the hands to go up and get it.
Now Templin is on Himes. And Himes with the hook, and that goes up and in. So you saw in that possession, Davidson clear out at the free throw line, and Osibor was stayed out there with him.
Right.
The three-point line. Still haven't seen Osborne get down into that post against KJ, but nonetheless, Ian Martinez steps up and hits.
Yeah, I'm surprised that the Aggies haven't tried to go to that more, but maybe they're giving Nevada a different look, which they've started to cut into the lead pretty succinctly in this half, so it might be a good thing for the Aggies.
Davidson tough in the post. And there it is, and one. Oh, he's playing so well. 22 points, 11 rebounds in that big win over San Jose State. And in this game, he's already got 13. He leads all scorers on the floor. The Wolfpack with the lead.
We're clearing out our inventory during Michael Hull Chevrolet GMC's winter clearance event. With a massive amount of new trucks ready for immediate delivery, we'll make you the deal of a lifetime. Save up to $10,000 off MSRP on new 2024 Chevy Silverado 1500s. Or save up to $10,000 off MSRP on new 2024 GMC Sierra 1500s. Hurry, these savings won't last long. During the winter clearance event at Michael Hull Chevrolet GMC in Carson City. Online at michaelhullgm.com.
Bet where the pros bet. With the world's largest sports book right at your fingertips. Circa Sports at Legends Bay Casino. Experience high limits, low holds, tight money line splits, and the best customer service. Now you can download, fund, and bet like a pro. Circa Sports at Legends Bay Casino. Sports betting the way it should be. Download your new bookie today. Visit circasports.com for details.
Here's a driver putting tires to the test, getting service and pricing that's always best from Ben. Big O's Ben. Lowest tire price guaranteed. He's the man that you go to see. It's Ben. Big O's Ben.
Get up to $160 in rebate savings on four select in-stock tires with installation purchase. Plus zero interest if paid in full within 12 to 6 months.
This is a Bradley Adrenaline Genet personal injury attorney. He's in his office, right here in Reno. Unlike a lot of Vegas personal injury attorneys who say they have a Reno office, our attorneys actually live here. Nothing against Vegas, but we know Reno and how to win cases here better than any Vegas lawyer ever could. Bradley Adrenaline Genet, the number one law firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Download the One Nevada app at onenevada.org/app.
Nice long run here, well deserved.
Yeah, I can't imagine any other coach at Utah State winning as many games as Coach Morrow won.
Well, first of all, you'd have to be here as long as he was, and that's rare.
But then to win as much as he won, even being here that long, I mean, that's a tall order for any coach.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun on Saturday night with all the former players, you and a lot of your ex-teammates. Here as well, Ian Martinez sizing up the three, and he drills it. Oh, the Aggies needed that. They've now hit five of their last six field goals. Yes, they have hit five of their last field goals.
I think Nevada's done a good job of keeping this crowd out of it. But if Aggies come up with a stop here.
Oh, Templin. A big block shot for Carson. And Ian Martinez trying to argue.
It looked like it went off Nevada on that play.
Let's take a look. I'm not sure I see that.
It was hard from the angle today.
Well, either way, Nevada keeps the basketball corner, Lucas. And an offensive rebound, but then it goes out of bounds. Which way? It's going to stay here.
And that's the thing. If you get a stop, you got to come up with the rebound. To keep putting pressure on Nevada. That's too easy.
Oh, wide open. And then, so what happens is Gray ends up with the foul. Because Daniel Foster got free.
See, and I think that's kind of indicative of how the Aggies have kind of let up in this game. It's plays like that. You need to keep your focus. You need to keep locked in on what preparation was. I'm sure they scouted the out-of-bounds place. And to let him come up with an easy layup and a foul for Great Osborne, that hurts.
Yeah, now Danny Sprinkle's got a decision to make because Osabor has picked up his third. So you got Osabor and K.J. Hines each with three fouls. But I would dare say in the way that these two teams run their offenses, Osabor probably means even more to the Aggies than Hines does.
Yes.
For Nevada. Osabor curls in. Osabor scores.
See, and they went away from swarming him on that play. If you let him have a dribble or two, he's probably going to get a foul or a bucket. And so I don't foresee Nevada letting that happen too often.
Templin again. Oh, they're going to get him for the foul. He had the block. And you're going to see this on the replay. So the block's good there, and then
that's a foul.
Yes. Hard to argue that.
Right.
Templin's come in and picked up a couple quick fouls, but he's played well. Yeah. How about that? The Aggie defense forces the turnover. And Aggies on a little bit of a scoring roll. They've made their last four shots. Osabor, of course, had that last layup in the post, and now he's being defended by Nick Davidson. Davidson, I mean, he's tough. Comes up with a steal right there, bodying up Osabor, and then the pass inside, but Osabor gets it right back.
That was a great hustle play. He ran from one end of the court to the other one to come up with that steal.
I don't think Daniel Foster ever saw him. That ball just slipped right out of Great's hands, I think. Oh, was he trying to get that to Templin? Either way, it's staying here.
Yeah, I think it just slipped out of his hands, and it's a little serendipitous that it went to the Aggies on that one.
Josh Aduje will check in. Templin will go to the bench. Good few minutes, though, for Templin. Picked up a couple fouls, but he hustled.
I agree. I think he came in and gave him a burst that they needed. And he's done that a couple times this year. For a freshman, he's showed a lot of poise and a lot of toughness that I think has really helped this Aggie team.
Brown just lost the ball on the way up. And here come the Wolfpack. Gotta watch Davidson when he gets that ball down low. And really, when he gets the ball anywhere, and there he goes. Offensive rebound, though. It's staying here. Another foul. Trey Coleman got the ball, and Aduje gets the foul. That's his first. Great might have cut himself.
Or lost a contact.
Or something. Either way, he's going to the bench. Yeah, you were right. You wear contacts?
No.
You picked that up quick.
That's why I could see what was happening.
And it's back in and ready to go. Because you don't wear contacts.
Right.
Oh, man. There's so many jokes that could go with that
one.
Feels like it's been 47 to 41 for a few minutes here. And here we go. A great game we've got going here. Mountain West Conference, a terrific basketball conference, a lot of good teams. Could have five or so teams in the tournament this year.
I say this every year, but.
Oh, no. Well, what were you going to say we can get our mind off what just happened?
Right.
Three
Brown
free throws coming.
Is the funnest player to watch on the defensive end. His hustle and the way he works. He's always got the toughest assignment. But it's little things like this. On this closeout, that's the little things that make the biggest difference is down the stretch. You put a player on to shoot three free throws on that.
So Martinez picking up the foul, and Wallison in the act of shooting. He's a good free throw shooter as well, 75%. Misses the first. But this Aggie crowd, you got to put them out of your mind. They are good. The herd, they call it. And this is the second. My goodness.
Those are some big misses.
Utah State is 10-0 at home this season. 13 straight home wins going back to last season. And this crowd, you got to give them a little credit. They're one of the reasons why. The longest win streak, of course, is your team. 19 back in 2008-2009, and the crowd was every bit as boisterous back then.
Oh, yeah.
Rollison finally hits the third.
It was a different experience for sure for player teams coming in here. They're just, the crowd's fantastic.
So 1 point has been scored in the last few minutes. Great, trying to change that. The ball will go out of bounds. He wanted the foul, but Daniel Foster knocks it out of bounds. I just can't say enough for how well Nick Davidson has been playing him in the post. You know, K.J. Himes has had some moments, but he's got the three fouls, so he's on the bench. And they'll go to Great again. And this time a reach in. Ooh, Wallace doesn't like that, but... So Rollison now has three.
We can see the Aggies, that's their game plan now, just to keep feeding it to them and hope that Great can make the decisions from the post to get it where it needs to go.
Martinez and Ian, he draws the foul. Free throws coming for Ian. And the foul goes to Davidson. And Davidson not in any foul trouble. That's his first, but you've got Rollison and Blackshear with three fouls each for Nevada on the floor. And you've got Osborne and Martinez with three fouls each, and they're on the court. So,
yeah, this is one of those
careful
games where each coach is willing to risk it down just because how tough their competitor is.
It's almost like they're saying, well, if you will, I will.
Right.
Ian Martinez, very good free throw shooter. Remember that Boise State, he hit all eight, including four in the overtime, four in a row in the last 15 seconds.
He had the layup and then,
hit the free throw. Yep. Nevada has not had a field goal in the last 3 minutes thanks to that Aggie defense. Davidson just gets free in the post. Somebody missed an assignment there, and he throws it down.
Yeah, and we've seen that a couple times. You have to trust your help side defense. If Osabor is going to help out that much on that high ball screen, you definitely have to have your help side come over, and they just didn't stay long enough. They were there, but then they left them before Great could get back and defend.
5-point game again. Darius Brown answers. Doesn't seem like it, but Brown only has 5 points in this game to go along with his 5 rebounds. Stepped out of bounds. Keenan Blackshear's having a little bit of a rough night tonight. Blackshear, 4 of 9 shooting. He does have 8 points, but 3 fouls and that turnover. Aggie basketball when we come back. Nevada by 5.
Pavers by Porter is unmatched in quality design, installation, and maintenance of interlocking pavers. We build your vision for your home or commercial locations. Call for a free estimate. Pavers by Porter, creating your dreamscape since 2007.
A foot has a lot of detail. It has a lot of complexity. There's a lot that can go wrong. A lot of problems start in the foot and end up elsewhere. Knee pain, hip pain, back pain. When aligning the feet properly, we can see relief elsewhere. And that's the beauty of the Good Feet Arch support. It can place the feet into their ideal position and gives them the balance, the support, the comfort, and the relief of the pain. The bottom line is that the Good Feet Arch support could be a highly effective pain relief solution when nothing else has worked.
See what we can do for you with a free arch support fitting at the Good Feet store.
Dear Winter, we're coming. Our squad of vehicles with all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive is ready to take you on. Safety's the name of our game. Bundle up. Toyota.
Toyota has 22 all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive vehicles, more than any other brand. Find yours at toyota.com. Toyota. Let's go places.
Pavers by Porter is unmatched in quality design, installation, and maintenance of interlocking pavers. We build your vision for your home or commercial locations. Call for a free estimate. Pavers by Porter, creating your dreamscape since 2007.
Are you ready to upgrade your home? Look no further than Envision Glass, your full-service glass experts. Our team of expert professionals offer a wide range of solutions, from residential repairs to full installations, to fit your budget with free in-home estimates. With Envision Glass, you can expect on-time arrivals, the highest quality materials, and exceptional workmanship. And installations are backed by our 5-year warranty. Trust the full-service glass experts. Choose Envision Glass for all your glass repair and upgrade needs. Visit EnvisionGlass.com.
Crowd is fired up here in Logan in the Spectrum. The Aggies 10-0 this season, but right now Nevada giving them all they can handle and more. The Wolfpack leading by 5, just under 12 to play here. Number of players have to be careful with their fouls. Martinez puts it on the floor. And Martinez gets the friendly roll, and it's a three-point game.
And Blackshear has to be a little bit careful with his fouls, too. So I think Martinez understands that and is being really aggressive with him because he's not going to be as physical.
We got a foul. Again, the official's pointing two different ways, but it's a Duje. Let's see if we can see this one. Oh, yeah, okay. That was pretty easy.
But the Aggies are in the bonus now, so most you can do to avoid fouling is going to be helpful to them.
Aduje with his second. So Himes now back in. He's got three. Himes and Blackshear both playing with three fouls. Osabor and Martinez both playing with three fouls. Lucas, the best free throw shooter in the building. Well, I can't speak for all the fans, but he's a 91 percenter. What a terrific player he has been for this Nevada team and Steve Alford. Graduate transfer from Oregon State originally. He's from California, but played at Oregon State. Makes it look easy. Lead is back to 5. We were just commenting that this game's not flying by.
No.
And it's just so physical. Every possession just means, and a 5-point lead. There's a foul in the post. Oh, that's going to be 4 on Himes.
And you could tell Great wanted that one. He came in with a vengeance. If you see him post up here, how hard he's going in there. He puts a lot of pressure on defenders and refs to have to make calls.
Yeah, you're right.
Not sure what the call is.
Yeah, I'm not. Official timeout. I guess they're going to review this because they think there might have been an elbow thrown. I'm not sure if we'll be able to get a replay. Again, we don't call for the replays here, but that's the situation that we're being told. Nevada leading 52-47 and an official review. See if we can find something here. Look in the post. Great right there. I don't see any elbows there. That's his physical play. Yeah, I can't.
I didn't see much.
Can't find anything there.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, the fans just enjoying themselves. I told you that we're on the same feed as the in-house TV. So as soon as they realize they're on TV, that's what happens. But it's a lot of fun. It's been a good season for us. We've enjoyed doing these games both on KMYU locally and on the Mountain West Network. And our broadcast tonight, going back to our friends in Nevada, that Nevada Sports Network. We did the same thing with football.
Yeah, I remember our battles with Nevada when I was here. They were always a force to be reckoned with. They had JaVale McGee, Nick Fizikas, Armand
Johnson. You played
JaVale McGee,
yeah.
That's right. And then Luke Babbitt.
They were
extremely talented players. Mark Fox was the coach when I was here. Yep. He went to Georgia.
Yeah, they've always had some really good competitive programs there off and on.
Yep.
I'm going to take the headset off and get the official word here. So, yeah, it's just a common foul. There is no elbow or anything like that thrown. So, but that's still the important thing is that's four fouls now. And obviously, Himes is back on the bench. He's struggled with fouls this whole game. Mason Falsip nearly loses it. And a travel.
Huh. Yeah, I'm not quite sure if I saw that, but you can look on the replay here.
Yeah, take a look.
Yeah.
Maybe a little stumble that resulted in the travel. So 5-point lead for Nevada. They have the basketball. Here we go. Blackshear in the post. Adugé working on him. And Blackshear turns. Good defense by Adugé. And here we go. Great Osabor. I mean, what can he do, right?
Yeah.
Brings the ball all the way up, drives inside, dishes out. Adugé in trouble, kicks out. Martinez. Osabor. And what are they calling here? This might be a foul on Great. I think it is. And if that's the case, that's four for Osabor. Take a look. Kind of threw it a little hard off. Wouldn't go in off the backboard. And there's the foul. I don't know. There was a lot going on both sides, but they call it on Great.
I'm not quite sure if there's more to that in terms of it seemed like he was just going for the rebound and wrong place, wrong time. But.
So Osabor and Himes each with four fouls. They've kind of mirrored each other throughout the game with the fouls. You know, they both got to two pretty quick, both got to three, now four. And that sends Blackshear to the free throw line. With his team leading by five. And now if you're Danny Sprinkle, you know you've got to be cautious with Osabor, but sooner or later he's got to get back in this game. Blackshear, 63% free throw shooter, 10.6 assists in their win over San Jose State. Next up for Nevada, they will host San Diego State. And next up for the Aggies, they will host Boise State. Mountain West Conference has been a lot of fun this year. Very good teams in basketball. Three of them nationally ranked. Utah State, San Diego State, and New Mexico. And a couple others most likely in the NCAA tournament. Johnson. Johnson working it. And Johnson a little too hard. And ball went out of bounds. So the Aggies will have it. There's only 5 seconds on the shot clock.
And this is where the Aggies have had to find a way to make things happen all year without Osabor on the floor. They become very stagnant on the offensive end and are hard-pressed to be able to find a guy that they can go to consistently to put points on the board.
Yeah, and Johnson can't get that one to fall. And the the foul trouble. You got Hines with four, Blackshear and Wallison with three each. And for the Aggies, Osabor with four, Martinez and Johnson with three each. Three-pointer, Blackshear, no. And here we go. False left, right to the rack, up and in.
And now the Aggies need to step up on the defensive end and keep this momentum going. This is where Nevada's been great so far. They've been able to silence the crowd, to stop the runs from the Aggies, and keep themselves ahead in this game.
Oh, that ball tipped way out. And turnover as Davidson fell down. No call, Aggie basketball. 5-point game, under 9 to go.
Converting in the half court is going to be extremely important heading down the stretch in this game for both teams. Being able to get stopped, get in the half court, and execute.
Oh, that ball just ripped right. Blackshear saw that pass coming the whole way and takes it down for the layup. Just snuck right in behind Johnson and stole it away. Johnson again on that baseline. Adugé for three. And how about Mason Falslev running that rebound down? And then Mason puts it up and in. Yeah, Falslev on a little bit of a roll himself.
That's why I say you can't take the play off after the shot goes up with him. He'll make you pay.
Falslev now with 12 points in this game, 5 rebounds.
In terms of his style, Mason reminds me a lot of Justin Bean. He's got a good motor.
Yeah.
He's got a good nose for the ball. He's tenacious.
Never stops. Three-pointer. This is big. And Davidson. Boy, he has been just sensational in this game. Davidson now with 18 points. Leads all scorers. Martinez for the Aggies has 16. You got to wonder, at what point does Danny Sprinkle bring Great Osabor back in the game? With four fouls, and there's a quick foul.
Let's put the Aggies in the bonus.
Foul on Trey Coleman. Yeah, another foul for Nevada. So free throws coming when we come back. We got a good one here. Aggies, Nevada. On KMYU locally and the Mountain West Network.
We've been in the biggest little city since its very beginning. We brought clean water to our city's first buildings and homes, when that wasn't easy to do. As our city has grown, we've grown with it. Since 1893, we've been trusted to do the right things the right way. Whether it's delivering innovative ideas for the buildings shaping our future, or making sure your leaky faucet leaks no more. That's the Savage way, and it has been for over 130 years.
Let me help. Let me help.
You've got this. You've got this.
Those were wild times. Betting squares for the big game has come a long way.
Now with the Circus Sports app, you can select your Circus squares right at your fingertips.
Everyone's played traditional squares at a big game watch party. Here at Circus Sports, we do it a whole lot better.
Select your own squares and as many as you want.
$1 minimum bet and a $100,000 maximum payout.
And best of all, no more arguing over the squares.
Circus Squares brought to you by Circus Sports, the world's largest sports book at your fingertips.
Wolfpack Moving in Northern Nevada offers exceptional and professional door-to-door moving services 7 days a week. Our clean-cut professional team will carefully pack and unpack all your items. Large or small, we handle it all.
Hey, Jared, we got everything?
Well, nice to see you, man. All right.
For affordable and professional moving services with flat hourly rates, call Wolfpack Moving Company, 775-900-7638.
8-point deficit for the Aggies here at home in the Spectrum. We haven't seen anything like this. I'm trying to think, in all the games we broadcasted this season, I don't think they've trailed by 8 this late in the game. Right. They have trailed.
Yeah, Colorado State was probably the closest one.
So Martinez with free throws, 83% free throw shooter. Guess I shouldn't have said that.
That's always the way it works.
Yeah.
I would tell the announcers when I played before the games, don't mention my free throw shooting. Yeah.
I usually do it right after. Yeah. I got a little ahead of myself there. My apologies to Ian. Although I doubt he heard me. We got a foul in the post on Aduje. It's a lot of work defending Nick Davidson. He's had an absolutely great game. 18 points on 8 of 12 shooting. And here comes great Osabor. And Danny Sprinkle just obviously feels like he's got to get him back in the game. You agree with that?
Yes.
7 minutes to play. And the potential to be down by 10 if Davison hits this freebie.
One thing is you got to know that whoever Osborne's guarding, that's who they're going to, because they're going to try to exploit that.
Yep. He's going to need foul disparity. Gonna need help.
Yep.
And two free throws connected for the young man from Mission Viejo, California. Nick Davison, just a sophomore, 6'9", 215-pounder. Played at Mater Dei. Osabor in the post, and he delivers. That's why he's in the game.
Yep. And they just have to keep going to that and then just play through that.
Blackshear just backing down Aduje and then kicks it out. And here he goes again. This time he just turns and shoots up and in.
That's a tough shot.
Tough shot.
Yep. Yep.
Back to a 10-point lead. And, of course, Osabor again. Martinez feeds him. Osmore doubled. Oh, what a pass. Aduje. No look behind. And Aduje delivers. And at the other end, Coleman trying to back in Mason Falslev, but they'll kick it out and reset. Lucas. Davidson so tough. Here he goes again. Not much Osabor can do. And again, a 10-point lead.
Yeah, at some point you can't keep trading baskets. You got to get some stops.
Falslev. Oh, look at him working. Just did not get the friendly bounce, and now approaching 5 to play in Nevada, up by 10 with the basketball. Blackshear. And Ian Martinez showing some good defense. And here comes Ian.
Ian likes the block, so.
Oh, dear. Falslev runs that down. Aduje, little short shot up and in. I think that might have gone off Osabor. He got a good look.
Yeah. When you get the shots that you want, you just got to make them fall. And then,
all right, so now you've got K.J. Himes back into the game with 4. So he and Osabor each with 4, and Nick Davison getting a rest. And they just took a timeout. So 4:29 to play, 65-55. Nevada has come in here 4-4 in league play. And they raced to a 15-1 start, but they're only 2-4 since then. But they look like a team that really wants to win tonight. And, Gary, they're coming off a 30-point drubbing against San Jose State.
Well, and that's why I feel like they have the look of a team that's got a lot of confidence right now.
Hey, Reno, how is your car looking? At Sierra Car Wash, a convenient clean is only minutes away. Visit any of our 11 express and full-service locations serving the Reno, Sparks, Carson City, and South Lake Tahoe communities. Save money on every car wash when you become a Sierra Unlimited member. Become an Unlimited member and never pay full price for a car wash again. No commitments, just clean. Find your neighborhood Sierra Car Wash at sierrawash.com.
If your personal injury attorney spends more time working on marketing than working on your case, you're probably in the market for a new personal injury attorney. At Bradley Drendel & Janay, our focus is on putting you first, not putting ourselves in front of the camera, which is why we didn't let our lawyers know we were filming today, so they'd keep their focus where it belongs, on you. Bradley Drendel & Janay, the number one law firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Dear Chairlift, let's try this my way. With available four-wheel drive that takes me straight to the top in style, and a wild side that's always ready for whatever's next. Keep it wild, 4Runner.
Every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, our no-cost maintenance plan. Visit your local Toyota dealer today. Find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
At The Joint Chiropractic, we believe that everyone should have access to high-quality, affordable chiropractic care. You are never too young or too old to start taking care of your body. Walk-ins are welcome at any of our five Northern Nevada locations for just $29, 7 days a week. Plus, as a monthly member, you can get treatment at any of our 900 nationwide locations. Stop living with pain. Try The Joint Chiropractic today and give your body the relief it needs.
And right now, Nevada looking pretty good, 65-55. Ball's tipped away. Here comes Darius Brown. Mason Falslev. Martinez, big three. And the shooting woes continue. Aggies have not shot well in this game, only 27%. Well, with that miss, 26% on threes, 39% overall. It has been rough.
Well, Aggies,
they actually don't go to Nevada this year.
Oh.
And that unbalanced schedule, that's a team they don't play at. So this is the only matchup of these two teams. And a foul called there. Been a lot of fouls in this game, too.
Yeah. Well, see, even here, we don't need to reach in. There's a player's off balance. He's going up. That's already going to be a tough shot. It's the mental discipline down the stretch that's going to make or break any team in this league.
Danny Sprinkle in his first season here with Utah State. Steve Alford, he's been around. He coached at Iowa. He coached at New Mexico. He coached at UCLA, now in his fifth year at Nevada. Really had a great start. Remember, they were 15-1 at one point. But yeah, they're 17-5 overall, but 4-4 in league. This would be a big win for them if they can hang on.
Well, and they're showing every bit of a 15-1 team right now in terms of how they're playing. Playing with a lot of confidence, trust in their teammates. You can see the look in their eye. It looks different than what the Aggies are showing right now. The Aggies are playing off their back foot. They're playing not to lose rather than just to win. And Nevada's coming up with the big plays when they need to. And I think that's just indicative of how games go, the look that the teams have.
Well, if the Aggies lose this game, Nevada hangs on to win. There's still plenty of time left. They would drop to their third loss in league play, but they host Boise State on Saturday. So that becomes a huge game. You turn around and win that, you're right back in first place again.
Right.
But there's still plenty of time to go with almost 4 minutes. Got to hit some shots, and as you always point out, you got to get stops.
Yep. Well, and I think that's that's the next step in the evolution of this Aggie team, is they're generally not in this position at home. And so what do you do? Yeah. What adjustments do you make to try to chip away at this lead? With the, you got plenty of time left. That's just what they need to figure out. I think for me, you put Osabor on the post and let and facilitate through him. He's got to know that the double team's coming. They got to be quick passes out of the post. And they've done that a couple times now. I just not the consistent enough approach to really see any dividends that it may be yielding.
Well, first of all, Keenan Blackshear at the free throw line. And he connects.
Now, Keenan's having a great game tonight.
He really is. 3 for 3 now at the free throw line for a 63% free throw shooter. 15 points, and he's played with 3 fouls almost its entire second half. Never picked up his fourth, hasn't yet. Blackshear from Orlando, transferred from FAU. You know, Steve Alford actually only starts 2 transfers. Hmm. 3 of these starters, Coleman, Davidson, and Himes, are, you know, original Nevada recruits and players.
That's becoming less and less.
Very much so. Oh, that's an unfortunate pass as Brown was trying to get it into a Duje, and it's a turnover. And now a 12-point lead for Nevada. In his regular rotation, he actually only has 4 transfers, and that's even more unusual.
Yeah.
In today's game.
Yeah. Well, he's got players on his team, that's the question for every coach. Am I going to be able to keep my team?
Yeah, right.
Because I think Nevada has all the pieces to be to make a real big splash in this conference.
Well, Foster is an example from Melbourne, Australia, and he's a senior. And he's played here his entire college career. Steps up and hits.
And it might be a little bit different for international players, especially with the NIL, because I don't think international players they're not here on a work visa.
Yeah,
so they can't.
True. Hits them both. And the lead now balloons to 14. Mm. Josh Aduje, he draws the foul, committed by Daniel Foster. But Foster, all the fouls that we've seen tonight, that's his first. Utah State has 2 players on the floor right now with 4 each. And Osabora Martinez, and Himes has 4 for Nevada, but he just picked up his first. Free throws coming for Josh Aduje.
And I think the fouls have been the difference maker for the Aggies in this game. They just got into foul trouble, put Nevada at the line early in the second half.
And an uncharacteristic miss for Aduje. Think about this. A lot of this run in the last couple minutes has come with Davidson on the bench. As you see, he just checked in for Himes. Perhaps sparing Himes the indignity of fouling out in front of this Aggie crowd, because there's nothing.
No.
You know, I wouldn't wish that on anybody.
Right.
I almost had that ball. Turnover. Lucas has it, though, and they're going to try to foul Lucas. Boy, talk about the one guy on the team. Well, they have a couple of them, but 91% free throw shooter. He's as bad, almost as automatic as you can get. Up and in.
Yeah, this is a good opportunity for the Aggies. It's a wake-up call heading into this last part of the season, that what it's going to take to actually, you know, go into the tournament, win the tournament,
right,
and make, you know, move into the NCAA tournament. This is a great Nevada team who's came out and wanted this game, at least up to this point, wanted this game more than the Aggies.
Well, Nevada's losses are at San Diego State, tough place to play. At Wyoming, that's always a tough road trip. As Aduje draws the foul. And they also lost at New Mexico, the Pit. You know that's a tough place to play.
Yeah.
And they lost to Boise State. So they've had four tough losses in league play.
Yeah, I mean, those are all the places that the Aggies have lost except for Boise State.
Boise State will be here on Saturday. And actually, Boise State actually beat Nevada at home. It's even more unusual. You know, this Mountain West Conference tournament, though, in Vegas is going to be a lot of fun. Yeah. I mean, that you get all these terrific teams on a neutral court. I mean, think about Utah State and San Diego State and New Mexico and Colorado State and even Nevada. Man, that's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah. That's what sets college basketball apart from any other sport is the, you know, March and that time. And it's so much fun to watch these players and these teams go out and just, you know, have these games that you never think are going to happen. And it's just good basketball.
Yep. Still more than a month away from now. A lot of regular season ball to play. Blackshear has to just launch that up. Gets the iron, but does not go. Aggies cannot waste any time. False left. No. And now with 2 minutes to go, 71-58. Nevada has come in here, and they have just taken control, especially in this second half. Remember, the Aggies got to within three at one point. And then that was the end of that. And Blackshear in the post. But I'll tell you this much. These two teams, they both fight.
Yes.
I mean, they work hard. It's been a very physical game and another turnover.
Yeah, I mean, I think the Aggies have played uncharacteristically unpoised basketball.
Yeah.
Nevada did a great job of taking them out of their offense early, putting players in foul trouble, and then executing down the stretch when they needed to come away with baskets. Like you said, they were almost – the Aggies cut the lead to three, and they came away and then stretched it to 15.
Now, and that young man has been awesome. Nick Davidson, 22 points now. Excuse me, 25. They just refreshed it with that last three. 25 points, 10 of 14 shooting. He's got three threes, and he has 10 rebounds. So a double-double for Nick Davidson.
Yeah, he came in, and he was the factor in this game for Nevada. Whenever they needed a basket, he came up with it. Whenever they needed a play, he came up with it. And he really showed that he's got a bright future here the next coming years in college basketball.
Well, and he's the third leading scorer on the team. But not tonight.
Well, you know, in the past couple games, even last game, he had 22 points.
Yeah, right. Hit three threes in that game against San Jose State. He had a double. This is his second double-double in a row.
I mean, all these players playing at the Division I level, they're all here for a reason. It's because they could play basketball. And you give a player an opportunity and a little bit of confidence, and that goes a long way for a basketball player.
Uh-oh. Got a hard foul here, and Lucas is holding on to his hand. But
kind of jammed
his finger.
Looks
like he's okay, yeah. Well, you don't want to see that. Lucas's numbers, when you look at him at the end of this game, they won't jump off the stat sheet. Well, I mean, as of now, he has 8 points, four assists, but he's done so many things just to help this team.
And that's, I mean, when you head down the stretch and you have your leading scorer who's willing to take kind of a back seat when another player is stepping up and try to facilitate, that's a sign of a good leader.
Seventeen-point lead. The Aggies are going to fall to 19-4 and 7-3 in league. And most likely, well, depending on what happens Saturday night, this would probably knock them out of the top 25.
Mm-hmm.
But there's still a lot of basketball to play. And then, of course, we talked about in the tournament, We're just talking about not wanting to foul out in this building, and unfortunately, Blackshear just did.
It's a lot easier to foul out when you're winning, though, too.
Well, that's true. The fans can yell whatever they want, but you can walk away with the scoreboard. Well, it's been a lot of fun to do these games. This was our 10th and final game, and I got to thank you for being willing to take this on. And we had never worked together when we started doing this, and it's been a blast.
It has been. You took a big risk.
I don't know if I can. No, you know the game, and you've done some broadcasting, and I think it was an easy choice.
It's been
a blast.
It's
a lot of fun, And next year, you should be back for more.
Yeah, if you'll have me back, I'll be back.
Absolutely. This season, they do have four more home games the Aggies do, and they're all on either CBS Sports or FS1 or other broadcasting entities. But we were fortunate to be able to pick up the 10 games that we did.
And we had some really good games.
Well, we went 9-1. That's pretty good.
That's a good record.
Yeah.
Next year we can make it 10-0.
Yeah, there you go. Lucas finish off with a three that won't go, and that should just about do it. Congratulations, Steve Alford, the fifth-year coach. His team gets above 500 in conference play. They'll go to 5-4. As Templin's three won't go. Duje's got the rebound and the putback. And Nevada will go to 18-5 overall.
Which is a phenomenal record.
Good season for the Wolfpack. And, Alford always does a good job with this team. And as I said, this is a tough league.
Yes, it is.
And it's going to continue to play that way. Well, Gary, thanks so much. Rough way to end our broadcast season, but lots more basketball to go. And I got to tell you, enjoy Saturday night. They'll be honoring your team from 2008-2009, as well as Stu Morrill, and naming this court after him.
Yeah, it's going to be a great night. Yeah. I think Coach Morrill, I can't think of a more deserving thing for him to be honored with. It was a joy to play for him, and I'm excited to see he's being recognized for all his hard work.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. Well, tough one tonight for the Aggies, but congratulations to Nevada. The Wolfpack come away with a victory, and we appreciate everybody for joining us on tonight's broadcast on the Mountain West Network, locally on KMYU and the Nevada Sports Network as well. So for our entire crew, they do such a great job for us here. Thanks, everybody, for joining us, and have a good night.
For 40 minutes, I have to be locked in. I can't worry about my feet. I would always, tape up and always get retaped because my feet were hurting. Nothing really was working. When I came into the Good Feet store and got fitted, I definitely felt the differences. Having the Good Feet support in your shoes just helps you not worry about your feet. I'm focused on the game, the task at hand. My goal is to have a long career. Focusing on foot health, using this arch support long term is definitely going to add to that. Even if you're not an athlete, invest in your feet. Good Feet arch support can definitely change your life.
Bet where the pros bet. With the world's largest sports book right at your fingertips. Circa Sports at Legends Bay Casino. Experience high limits, low holds, tight money line splits, and the best customer service. Now you can download, fund, and bet like a pro. Circa Sports at Legends Bay Casino. Sports betting the way it should be. Download your new bookie today. Visit circasports.com for details.
I've seen it 1,000 times. Insurance companies do everything they can to deny a claim. It's frustrating. That's why I made it easy. Text me anytime and get an answer. I'm local and have years of experience getting people like you fast and easy resolutions.
Here's a driver putting tires to the test, getting service and pricing that's always best from Ben. Big O's Ben. Lowest tire price guaranteed. He's the man that you go to see. It's Ben. Big O's Ben.
Get up to $160 in rebate savings on 4 select in-stock tires with installation purchase. Plus zero interest if paid in full within 12 to 6 months.
Pavers by Porter is unmatched in quality design, installation, and maintenance of interlocking pavers. We build your vision for your home or commercial locations. Call for a free estimate. Pavers by Porter, creating your dreamscape since 2007.
Dear winter, we're coming. Our squad of vehicles with all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive is ready to take you on. Safety's the name of our game. Bundle up. Toyota.
Toyota has 22 all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive vehicles, more than any other brand. Find yours at toyota.com. Toyota. Let's go places.
Wolfpack Moving in Northern Nevada offers exceptional and professional door-to-door moving services 7 days a week. Our clean-cut professional team will carefully pack and unpack all your items. Large or small, we handle it all.
Hey, Jared, we got everything?
Well, nice to see you, man. All right.
For affordable and professional moving services with flat hourly rates, call Wolfpack Moving Company, 775-900-7638.
From seed to cup, every step of this process is important. But most of all, we get to roast the coffee here in Reno, Nevada. As a former Nevada track athlete, giving back to my alma mater means the world to me. Morning Howl Coffee is our way of doing that. For every bag sold, whether it's at our cafes, online, or at grocery stores, a portion of those proceeds go back to Nevada Athletics. Go Pack!
Pavers by Porter is unmatched in quality design, installation, and maintenance of interlocking pavers. We build your vision for your home or commercial locations. Call for a free estimate. Pavers by Porter, creating your dreamscape since 2007.
Watch high school basketball on Champion Chevrolet's High School Hoops, presented by America First Credit Union. Tune in Friday at 7 on NSN.
Hi, I'm Peja Stojakovic.
I'm Andre.
He got his size from me, his jump shot from me, and his feet, also from me.
Wow, thanks.
To take care of those feet, I got him the Good Feet 3-Step Arch Support System.
Good Feet Arch Supports are designed to help relieve foot-related pain by putting the foot into a more ideal pain-relieving position.
These feel great.
Everybody needs Good Feet, even my son.
Okay, let's do some math. One, huge selection. Two, no dealer markups. Three, lower taxes. Four, 65 miles to savings. You don't have to be a mathematician to see these numbers add up to Wild West Chevrolet being the smart choice. What's your number? Check us out online or in Yerington.
We've been in the biggest little city since its very beginning. We brought clean water to our city's first buildings and homes when that wasn't easy to do. As our city has grown, we've grown with it. Since 1893, we've been trusted to do the right things the right way. Whether it's delivering innovative ideas for the buildings shaping our future, or making sure your leaky faucet leaks no more. That's the Savage way, and it has been for over 130 years.
Hey Reno, how is your car looking? At Sierra Car Wash, a convenient clean is only minutes away. Visit any of our 11 express and full service locations serving the Reno, Sparks, Carson City, and South Lake Tahoe communities. Save money on every car wash when you become a Sierra Unlimited member. Become an Unlimited member and never pay full price for a car wash again. No commitments, just clean. Find your neighborhood Sierra Car Wash at sierrawash.com.
Welcome inside our Champion Chevrolet NSN studio. Chris Murray, Alex Margulies. For those of you just watched the Nevada-Utah State game, highlights and analysis of that one can be found tonight on Fox at 10:30 as part of that program on NSN tonight, or at 11 o'clock on News 4. Lots to get to on this show, though, Chris. We got Murray's mailbag to dive into, a sit-down interview with Joey Thomas, and Super Bowl opening night. Shannon Kelly already hitting the ground running down in Vegas.
Yeah, she's getting a lot of stuff for us. So she's going to be down there all week. But some good stuff from Asani Rufus and from Brandon Ayuk, both trying to win a Super Bowl ring with the 49ers.
All right. This first segment, we're getting you dialed for signing day, which is coming up on Wednesday. And the Wolfpack football, I think this has to be a class. And right now it's on paper. We don't know exactly what it's going to look like now, Chris. But this is a really solid job, I think, in a short period of time for a new coaching staff coming in and hitting the ground running. We'll start first, guy you certainly need to know, and that's quarterback Chubba Purdy.
Yeah.
Definitely a name that's going to catch your attention. One, because of the first name, and more importantly, because of the last name.
When all said and done, there'll probably be 25 to 30 players announced tomorrow. We're going to give you a five to watch, and certainly this is a big name. He's played at Florida State. He's played at Nebraska. He's started five college football games. He's got dual threat ability, so I think he'll fit the offense. Certainly that last name is a big one. His first name, not actually Chubba, it's Preston, but he was named that when he was really young because he was a big baby. Not in like a crying way. He was just a large child, and certainly is going to be a big piece of what Nevada is trying to put together. He's not certainly going to be handed the job. You're going to have A.J. Bianco. You're going to have Brendan Lewis still in that mix as well. But this is a guy who's going to be here for spring camp. And it'll be very interesting to see if he's able to create some separation between him and the rest of the pack as Nevada gets to the offseason. But, yeah, this is certainly a big name. And I think excited a lot of Wolfpack fans when he did commit.
All right. Also on the offensive side of the ball, some slew of running backs coming in, including Patrick Garwood, the third from Boston College.
They could have eight scholarship running backs this year. You look at Garwood, he's probably the most productive of the transfers Nevada's expected to sign. Almost 2,000 rushing yards during his career at Boston College, 11 touchdowns. He was all ACC in 2021. He's had some injuries since then, but I think he brings a different dynamic to the backfield in terms of his power. He's more of a bowling ball back.
What kind of highlights for you on the defensive side of the ball?
Yeah, you look at defensive backs. Catan Crawford, he's from Texas, came with Jeff Choate. 46 games with four starts, very athletic, very experienced, should be able to step in and help replace Amani Johnson and Richard Toney. You look at linebacker Caden Johnson. He was a former four-star recruit. Played most recently at Wisconsin, where he played 35 games. He's got a lot of potential as an edge rusher. And then another defensive back, Keyshawn Cobb, one of three transfers from West Virginia. He also played at Buffalo in 2022, 66 tackles. So there's a lot of transfers, and I agree with you. I think they've done a really good job, considering Jeff Choate got this job about 2 weeks before the December signing period, to be able to put together what looks like a reasonably solid class, putting a lot of the scholarships into this late period, which will be announced tomorrow. I think he's done phenomenal work. We'll see how many of them pan out, but there's a lot of talent coming into this program.
Also, some news on the prep side of things.
Yeah, they got a couple of defensive linemen from Texas. Not really highly accoladed guys, but Jason Douglas Jr. and Caleb Latham. I think Douglas Jr. is the one to watch out for. He had 19 and a half sacks for DeSoto. And DeSoto was number five team in the entire nation last year, undefeated. So a very talented player who kind of fell through the cracks. Jaquise Smith is Nevada's new defensive ends coach. This is a guy who grew up in Dallas, played in the NFL for a long time, was on Texas's staff last year. So he's got some connections back there and able to get a couple of what they hope to be hidden gems. But yeah, all the way up to signing day, there's getting these commitments. One piece of bad news for Nevada, they did lose the commitment of Owen Long. He was an athlete from Southern California, committed to the Wolfpack 2 weeks ago, decommitted, and now we'll be signing with Colorado State and Jay Norvell. So I'm sure Wolfpack fans not thrilled with that. But all in all, there should be a ton of players announced tomorrow. And like you said, I think this is a solid class. It's a good foundation to try and improve this roster heading into 2024. A
lot of content to come from signing day, including a one-on-one conversation with head coach Jeff Choate. We'll have that for you. Our special hour-long edition of NSN tonight. We're going to be doing that tomorrow from Legends Bay Casino, gearing up for a big week of sports, including the big game on Sunday between the Niners and the Chiefs. Coming next on today's show, we're going to dive into Murray's mailbag. We'll have that and much more coming up on this edition of NSN tonight. Next.
Child hunger is real. Every day, far too many children go hungry. For many, their only meal is a free school breakfast or lunch. For just $5, you can help a hungry child eat on the weekend.
Make a difference by supporting the Super Bowl of Caring food drive on Friday, February 9th at Smith's on South Meadows Parkway, or donate now at mynews4.com.
Beat the New Year's rush and join European Fitness Center today. Other gyms advertise low rates but charge extra fees, but at European Fitness Center, it's just zero to join and only 20 per month with no hidden fees. We're European Fitness Center. Get in and get fit today.
Here's a driver putting tires to the test, getting service and pricing that's always best from Ben. Big O's Ben. Lowest tire price guaranteed. He's the man that you go to see. It's Ben. Big O's Ben.
Get up to $160 in rebate savings on 4 select in-stock tires with installation purchase. Plus zero interest if paid in full within 12 to 6 months.
Is your house catching a cold? It could be furnace problems. Schedule a tune-up today. Call Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air for all your home heating needs. With over 20 years of being locally owned, Michael's Plumbing, Heating, and Air is your go-to for home heating because we treat our customers like family.
Hi, I'm Jeff of the Compani Auto Group. We want to encourage our youth to seek diverse ways to secure a solid future through trades, apprenticeships, and two-year programs that teach hands-on skills for specific careers.
One great thing I love about the electrical industry is that you can come in and earn as you learn. You are actually providing for your family and show that women can lead the way.
Here at Compani Auto Group, we're proud to support the Driving Brighter Futures campaign.
Watch coverage of the big game all week long, presented by Circa Sportsbook, inside Legends Bay Casino.
This segment sponsored by Laub and Laub.
All right, it is that time. We're diving into the mailbag. And, of course, you can submit your questions every week on Twitter. Let's dive right into it. Nicholas Prabilla, who's your award winners? I'm assuming basketball.
Mm-hmm.
Award winners, first team, et cetera. And where do you think Nevada will finish?
I'm going to say Nevada finishes sixth. Okay. I do think there's a solid chance they can get up to fifth, and I think you do have to get that bye because no team has ever won four games in four nights to win the Mountain West Tournament. In terms of your award winners, I'm going Jaden Ledee for the overall player of the year. If you look at newcomer of the year, Great Ozabor of Utah State, the transfer from Montana State. Head coach Danny Sprinkle of Utah State. I think he's a pretty clear-cut coach of the year. Freshman of the year, JT Toppin from New Mexico. And my defensive player of the year, I'm going Trey Coleman. You don't see a lot of wings win this award. I think Trey has earned it. And if you look at my first team, all Mountain West, I got one Wolfpack player, Keenan Blackshear, currently in my top five players in the conference. So that's who I would award these trophies to. But still, a lot of games still left to be played. We'll see if some of those things change.
All right, if there was one guy that you could maybe challenge Ledee for player of the year, it seems like he's got a pretty good strangle on it right now. Is there maybe a 1A?
I think Great Ozabor, because if you're looking at how the coaches do it, they only vote based on Mountain West play.
There you go.
And Ledee was phenomenal in non-league. Not that he's not been good in the Mountain West. I think if Utah State ends up winning the whole thing, I think Ozabor could end up being the one who wins player of the year.
All right, lots to still be decided there. Let's go to @defend_Lawler. He wants to know, is there a range of final season net KenPom numbers over the years? This is basically a lock to make the NCAA tournament. I don't think anything's necessarily a lock, but what about a range that's about 50-50?
Yeah, so if you go back to 2018, that's when net was created. If you're 40 or better in net since 2018, only four teams in the top 40 have not made the NCAA tournament. One of them last year was Rutgers, number 40, and there was some controversy about Nevada getting the last
spot. I remember that,
Although Nevada was 36, I think, in the net last year. So
they were like under 500 in their league.
So I think that's where you got to be. Top 40 in net, you're in the tournament barring kind of a catastrophe. Uh-huh. Nevada right now is around 65 in net. So certainly a lot of work to be done. If you're looking more at 50-50, if you're in that 45 to 50 range, you're probably on the wrong side of the bubble. So getting into the top 40 is really the goal because history has shown if you're top 40 in net, you are dancing.
All right. So next question comes from, I think it's Jamie T. Jr. Asking, to me, McIntosh was the promising factor for 2022-2023 coming in from Elon. He gets injured. And then hopes for this season, but Jamie's saying he is nowhere I thought he would be. What are we missing here?
I mean, he hasn't had maybe the career he envisioned when he came to Nevada, but that knee injury before last season changed everything. He was going to step into a point guard role. Now he's playing off the ball, which is kind of what he did do at Elon. Now he's been a capable three-point shooter, shooting right around 39% from the field, but about 4.5 points per game. I think Wolfpack fans may be expecting a little bit more. This guy's a phenomenal student as well. Like, I'm not going to sit here and rip him because he is trying his best. He is a very good leader. He's very good in terms of his academics. Maybe he hasn't lived up to what he was hoping he would do at Nevada, but that's a big jump from Elon up to the Mountain West. That's the CAA. Nevada has not had a lot of success with those low major transfers. Mm-hmm. It's usually been the high major transfers, the Power Five guys, and maybe some guys from really strong mid-major programs. So I still think you're going to see a game or two from Hunter McIntosh where he comes in and hits two or three threes, and he's a difference maker down the stretch. but certainly probably not the kind of production a lot of Wolfpack fans and even maybe Hunter McIntosh himself were expecting. But I know in the feature we had on Wolfpack All Access, he told our Shannon Kelly, he's here to win games. Uh-huh. He just wants Nevada to win, and I think he's willing to do whatever role needs to be required of him to try and help that
game. He's been very unselfish because I feel like he could take more shots, and maybe he should, actually. I don't think Nevada gets him involved maybe enough, because earlier in the season we were seeing him get going, and he was a big factor off the bench. But there's a lot of games he doesn't even take a shot, maybe take one shot. You know, a guy that's shooting 39% from three, I'd like to see him get a little bit more volume, and maybe that's something we'll see down the stretch.
He started 3 years at Elon, so this is a different role. Coming off the bench, trying to play a role and not being quite as dominant with the ball.
All right. Royce underscore boy, what do you make of Gloria Navarro's announcements last week about the plan to become, quote, the most highly respected, best-in-class national athletics conference? Is this a realistic ambition? Will it yield any results? If not, are they delusional, or is it just hype?
Well, they put out basically a five-year prospectus on what they hope the Mountain West to be, kind of a pathway to success. I don't put a lot of stock in a strategic plan, but, you know, it's a structure, and they're trying to keep these schools together. I think the bottom line is the Mountain West is in a very strong position. This could be the number five conference in all of Division I athletics, and had you told people that 6 or 7 months ago when the tectonic plates started shifting with the Pac-12, people would have laughed in your face. So the Mountain West is in a strong position. I think their commissioner, Gloria Navarro, is very good at her job, and I do think it's a bright future for the Mountain West as long as they stick together, and this whole plan was trying to keep them together through, you know, very turbulent times in college athletics.
All right, maybe Mountain West trending up compared again. If you'd ask who's going to survive in 5 years, Pac-12 or Mountain West, no one's going to think Pac-12 after 100 years is going to shudder, but that could be what we're looking at here in the next couple of years. All right, so that is Murray's Mailbag. You can find the full write-up online at NevadaSportsNets.com. Coming up next, Joey Thomas joins us in studio, and later on, Shannon Kelly has her first of many reports this week from Las Vegas at the Super Bowl, getting ready for the Chiefs and the 49ers.
Dear chairlift, let's try this my way. With available four-wheel drive that takes me straight to the top in style, and a wild side that's always ready for whatever's next. Keep it wild, 4Runner.
Every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, our no-cost maintenance plan. Visit your local Toyota dealer today. Find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
We're the Jansons with SierraBuys.com.
We know the easiest way to sell your home.
If you have a few minutes, we hope that you'll give us the opportunity to make you an instant offer on your house. With SierraBuys.com, we'll buy your house in as-is condition with no inspection, no repairs, no closing costs, and no commissions. You can even choose your own closing date.
Call our dad for an offer on your house.
455-4500 to sell your house today.
There are a lot of reasons why people become attorneys. I wanted to help people. That's why I'm changing the game. Text me today and get an answer today. I don't get paid until you get paid. Simple, local, easy. Text or call me today.
Hi, I'm Jeff Compagni of Compagni Auto Group. Our highest priority is keeping our drivers safe and out of harm's way. Here's the Washoe County Sheriff's Office with some tips to help you do just that.
No matter how safe we are, traffic accidents are just a part of life. However, there are some steps you can take to keep yourself safe after an accident. If you are injured, call 911 or ask someone to do so right away. If you are not injured, get yourself to safety right away and then call 911 and document the accident from a safe distance.
From Compagni Auto Group, drive safe, Nevada.
Hi, I'm Coach Chris Ault, and you're watching Nevada Sportsnet.
Welcome back to NSN Tonight. I am Chris Murray in the Legends Bay Lounge, powered by Circa Sports, with a new Nevada assistant football coach, Joey Thomas. You're the passing game coordinator and secondary coach for the Wolfpack. So I guess, how's your introduction to Reno been your first couple of weeks here?
It's been great. I've actually spent more time on the road than I have here, but the times that I have been here, it's been snowy, but the people have been phenomenal.
Yeah, that's good to hear. So you come from Texas. You were there with Coach Cho, but I want to go a little bit into your backstory. Born and raised in the Seattle area.
Yes.
Was an All-American at Montana State. You were a third-round draft pick of the Green Bay Packers, spent several years in the league. So talk to us a little bit about your playing career. What are maybe some of your most fond memories of playing football at the professional level, or maybe even with the Bobcats?
Like you said, you know, I'm from Seattle, Washington. I would probably say one of my fondest memories would be high school. You know, spending that time, you know, with my brothers. You know, we're still close to this day. I think the next biggest moment would be at Montana State breaking the streak. We had lost, I believe, 16 years in a row to that other team in the state of Montana. And I was able to block a field goal to help propel us to victory. So that was like a big deal because it wasn't just about me. It was about the city, it was about the state, it was about what we did together. And then probably the first playoff game my rookie year. You know, I've been to the playoffs every year, almost every year of my career, but I think the first one was special to do it in Lambeau and to be a part of that and, you know, all that tradition. So I've been saying go Pack go for a long time.
Yeah, that works here when you're with the Nevada Wolfpack, a little bit different than the other pack. And there's a great Wolfpack player, Romeo Doubs, who's on the Green Bay Packers. So I'm sure you've enjoyed watching him play. From there, you get into coaching. You actually go to the high school ranks back to Seattle. So is that something you knew you always wanted to do, was be a coach? Or is that something that kind of popped up once the playing career was over?
Well, I'm a son of a coach, so it's in me, not on me. When I retired, I didn't know what I wanted to do. You know, I was like, kind of like, what's next? I had an opportunity come about. Someone asked me, do you want to be a high school head coach? I had nothing going on at the time, and I said, why not? And that's kind of how I fell into it. But once I got into it, I knew that's where my calling was, because it's not about football. Football is just a vessel, but it's about the people and teaching them tangible life skills through sports. So it was an opportunity to pour into young men. And, you know, once I got my feet wet, you know, things just took off.
Yeah, you had a lot of success. You had two different stints, about over a decade, your second stint with Garfield. I think Wolfpack fans might know Garfield High as the alma mater of Marcellus Kemp, a great Nevada basketball player. Not necessarily known for their football, but you guys did a really good job. So I guess, what did you learn from building those programs up, kind of from scratch, kind of with the blue-collar mentality that Nevada has to have to be successful?
It's all about changing the culture. You have to change the mindset. Typically, when you come in, when programs are struggling, regardless of the level, there's a lack of belief. So you have to give structure and you have to give them something to believe in, something to believe into, and most of the time, that's you. Mm-hmm. You are what they find their trust and their belief in. So being consistent, obviously you have to know what you're talking about and what you're doing, but the football part of it's easy. This is really about people and how you deal with people. Can you inspire people? Can you motivate people? Can you pour into people? Can you make it bigger than you? And I think when you understand those pillars, it's easy to create a launch, and that's what we're going to do here at Nevada.
Obviously, Nevada needs a bit of a culture change, back-to-back 2-10 seasons. So take us through a little bit of the conversations you've had with your players as you try and get this program on the right track.
Everyone's starting from scratch. You know, what you did last year does not matter. It's a clean slate. We're going to evaluate you on what you do today. And it's about being consistent. You know, it's hard to build anything or to be able to count on someone when they're up and down. But if you're going to be this guy, I need you to be this guy all the time. If you're here, I need you to be that person consistently all the time. But it's also showing them how to be consistent. You know, one of the things that we found being here at Nevada is these young men want to do right. They want to get it right. So now it's our job is to show them what that looks like on a consistent basis.
When we look at your career, we talked about the high school ranks. From there, you went to a junior college to be an assistant coach in Kansas.
Yes.
So walk us through that decision to go from being a successful high school coach in Seattle
to
a junior college assistant coach in Kansas.
Okay, so I did about a decade in Seattle, Washington, and helped over 119 kids go to college. From my stint, along with my coaching staff. No one does it by themselves. It takes a great staff. It takes a community, actually, to have that type of success. But I wanted more. As a competitor, it was never about winning state championships, but it was about providing opportunity for young men to get an education on someone else's dime. Like, that was my whole goal. I did it in the North End, and then I came back and did it in my neighborhood. I wanted to see kids get a free education. But after a while, I needed more. The competitor in me said, I need more. And I was seeing coaches come in and recruit my school, and I'm looking and I'm like, man, I could do that. Yeah. And I had a lot of opportunities come before me, and I said no, just because I didn't want to move, I didn't want to go on the road. And then an opportunity came to go to JUCO, and I thought about it, and I wasn't going to take it. But when I found out that they hadn't had a lot of success and that they struggled, that really got my attention. I love those type of opportunities. I'm a builder. I've been a builder my whole life. Like, I'm the guy that goes to the career mode in Madden and I build my franchise. Like, that's who I am. Yeah. I love to pour in to people, and I love the point of situation. So I went to Fort Scott. I was there for a year. We had some success, and then from there I went on to coach at Florida Atlantic in Boca Raton, a very beautiful place. And then from that opportunity, I linked in again with Coach Choate, saw him at a championship game. We had a good conversation. I've been knowing Coach Choate for almost 20 years now, and the opportunity to go to UT came about. So when I was at Florida Atlantic, I was actually coaching receivers. So that was phenomenal because it gave me an opportunity to coach in the offensive side of the ball. So I've actually spent 10 years in the offensive side of the ball now. But going to UT, I came back and I was in the secondary, and it's good to be home doing what I did as a player. So, did the 2 years at UT to help that secondary in every way that I could. And now I'm here at Nevada.
So I want to ask about your relationship with Coach Choate. First, I guess, what do you think makes it you a builder? What is it about your personality, your upbringing that, I guess, draws you to positions like that?
It's a great question. I'm happy you asked. So I played on Sundays, right? But everybody looks at the outcome, but nobody understands the process. No one understands the highs and the lows and the adversity that you have to go through to get there. I'm a builder because I had to build myself, I came up in a time to where I was the unbelieved in, I was the underdog. They didn't believe in me. Obviously I had a couple people believe in me in my journey, but the masses said I wasn't good enough. The masses said I wouldn't do it. And so I had to be my biggest cheerleader. I'm confident because I had to be confident. You live in a world that's always gonna tear you down. So I'm gonna love on me. And I learned how to manifest my success through positive self-talk and hard work. So when I see situations that they say are dire or can't be done, to me, I identify with that because that's been my life. They've told me what I can't do, but I'm gonna show you what I can do. So it's in me, not on me. And so because I understand my personal recipe, I truly believe that I could always duplicate success thus far.
So last year you were at Texas on staff with Coach Choate on the defensive staff there, but that's not where your relationship started. As you said, you've known him a long time. So take us back to that first meeting and maybe what your first impression was of him.
So when Coach Choate finally got to Montana State, I was hearing, there's this new head coach, he got some swagger to him, he's cool, JT, you got to meet him. And I was like, okay, all right, we'll see. So I'm coaching at Ballard High School. Coach Choate comes in, with his bop and his step. And I'm like, we had a conversation. I was like, this dude gets it. He actually gets it. And for me, in my experience, it's a rarity when you find someone that understands the pillars of success. Because when you understand the pillars of success, you can always duplicate it. And in our 45-minute conversation, I was kind of bobbing my head like the Bobcats have a chance. Mm-hmm. They're going to be okay. So that's kind of where the relationship started. He would recruit my kids. He would recruit the state of Washington because he kind of knew that I knew who was who and what's what. And we just developed a relationship, stayed in touch. And I almost came to work for him a little earlier in my career, but I decided to stay at the high school ranks. And so, the stars aligned and, when this opportunity came about, it was a no-brainer. But the one thing I can tell you about Coach Choate that I can guarantee you, he's been successful everywhere he's gone, and there's a reason for that, because the man understands the recipe. That's why his position groups are always successful. That's why his teams are always successful. So if you give it time and you buy into the formula, you will be successful. You have no choice. You will be successful. And that's one of the things that I've kind of admired about him, how he builds culture. So for someone like myself who wants to be a head coach, it's been a privilege to watch him, how he did it at Texas in his room and how he's done it everywhere he's been, including Montana State.
I think I could talk to you forever, but our time is up here. Thank you so much for coming into the studios and best of luck this season with the Wolfpack.
I appreciate you.
All right, we'll be right back on NSN Tonight after this break.
This is what a fight looks like. That's right. This is an attorney at Bradley Drendel & Janay fighting for a client. It may be hard to tell, but he's winning big. Maybe we should add some fight sound effects to make it more thrilling to watch at home. Okay, watching us fight isn't that exciting, unless you're the client that just notched a big win. Bradley Drendel & Janay, the number one firm for people who want to be treated like they're number one.
Child hunger is real. Every day, far too many children go hungry. For many, their only meal is a free school breakfast or lunch. For just $5, you can help a hungry child eat on the weekend.
Make a difference by supporting the Super Bowl of Caring food drive on Friday, February 9th at Smith's on South Meadows Parkway, or donate now at mynews4.com.
Where else can you join a full-service gym for just $20 per month? European Fitness Center. We've just finished our $500,000 renovation to bring you all the newest equipment and most satisfying experience all around. For only $20 per month, you'll gain access to the gym and all its amenities, including free personal trainers, spa, swimming pool, cardio theaters, and more. That's zero to join and just $20 per month with no hidden fees. It's the brand new European Fitness Center. Get in and get fit today.
With a Chevy, you get more than just a vehicle you can depend on. A Chevy gives you the freedom to explore new roads, to push the limits, and go places you've never been before. So buckle up and get ready to enjoy the ride as you set off on new adventures. See where a new Chevy will take you at Champion Chevrolet, home of the hardest working cars and trucks in America. Discover the new Chevy experience at Champion Chevrolet.
This segment sponsored by Circa Sports.
Super Bowl 58's opening night is in the books in Las Vegas as more than 23,000 fans piled in to Allegiant Stadium to welcome the Kansas City Chiefs and the San Francisco 49ers. Now, it's a rematch from 4 years ago, but for many of these 49ers, they're playing in their first ever big game, including McQueen High alum Brandon Ayuk and quarterback Brock Purdy. Here's some of the guys from opening night.
Being on teams that didn't get it done, that didn't get to play up to the level that they were supposed to, and being conversations of playing in championship games, Super Bowl games, I feel like being on teams like that kind of definitely does build that hunger that you have playing in games like this, because now you're here on this stage, and it's, you know that feeling, and you have an option on whether you want to feel it or not. So you can do everything in your power to try to control that outcome. Here in the Super on the biggest stage, the greatest time of the year, playing football, to write all those stories, write all those wrongs. I'm sure we sitting here today holding up trophies and celebrating. We won't be thinking about any losses back in college or any time other than that. It's all about right now, and we feel like the time is now.
I think it's just cool how it all is in a way, you know, full circle. I got drafted here last, and then now here we are 2 years later to get ready to play in the Super Bowl. I think it's pretty cool. I'm very grateful for it more than anything. And so, yeah, here we are. What a great opportunity. That's how I'm looking at it.
We need them to be loud. I know they will. They're going to show up and show out and support and, you know, try to make this a home game. It'll be a long time coming. I can only imagine a parade in San Francisco and how awesome that would be. Celebrate that one for a very long time.
Our coverage from Las Vegas is just getting started, as we'll have all the action throughout the week on Nevada Sportsnet News 4 and Fox 11 leading up to the big game on Sunday afternoon. Reporting at Allegiant Stadium, Shannon Kelly, Nevada Sportsnet.
All right. Thank you very much, Shannon, for that. Takes us straight into our NSN poll of the weekend. Who's the best Northern Nevada high school football player ever? Brandon Ayuk taking that top spot. And I don't think many people would have said that 5 years ago, but he's playing in the Super Bowl now.
I think you got to go longevity. Kyle Van Noy, a decade in the league, two Super Bowl rings, but individual season, Brandon Ayuk. And I think by the end, it will be him.
Don't forget about the champ, Austin Corbett, either. Some good players in that list. See you guys tomorrow.
Child hunger is real. Every day, far too many children go hungry. For many, their only meal is a free school breakfast or lunch. For just $5, you can help a hungry child eat on the weekend.
Join America First Credit Union in our effort to end child hunger in Northern Nevada. Please help by donating to the Super Bowl of Caring at mynews4.com.
Help make a difference today. Donate to the Super Bowl of Caring.
On average, 26.8 million Americans become infected with the flu every year. There's been a steady increase in the flu-related hospitalizations over the last 6 weeks in Nevada, and we encourage you to get your flu shot now. It's not too late. It's also not too late to get the latest COVID-19 and RSV vaccines. Contact your healthcare provider to learn more or visit immunizenevada.org. That's immunizenevada.org.
Watch coverage of the big game all week long, presented by Circa Sportsbook inside Legends Bay Casino.
Nevada Sportsnet is your home for all Wolfpack athletics.
We now join the following program already in progress.
T. Pope's energy. They gave us what we got to have off the bench, both offensively and defensively. Really, in particular for TR in the first half. I thought he guarded, and he earned more minutes in the second half. And that's what, as a young player, he's got to keep learning that.